Peace. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice of your good brother, the Kahan Tazadaq. This is your housework. And so once again, about to drop something for you punk-tified Simp Beta males. And something else, for you guys that pretend that you're not a Simp Beta male, and you know, you try and talk that talk like, you're really an alpha male, but you're really not, because the proof is in the pudding. And so basically, you know, this stream right here is for simp males that want to really learn how to pick up women. And essentially, for you fake dudes that you pretend that you're an alpha male, but you're really not, because I could determine, I could see it how you move. Some of you do all kind of things to appease the women. Some of you want to do this. Yeah, me trying to rap. Still want to keep that thuggish stuff in it. And you're just not good with women. And you're wondering why. Like, damn, how this dude, you know what I mean? Tazadaq, man, he talked that talk, man. But he be walking that walk, man. How come I can't? You're in the background, you be like, how come I can't do that? And you be envying on me, man. You be hating on cats like me, man. But, I mean, you just say, you just don't have it, man. But you're like, Tazadaq is a chick magnet, man. How come I can't be like that, man? But you envy me for it. You hate me for it. So I'm going to give you the game, man. So go ahead, as you come in the room, I mean, I know you might feel a little upset, angry. Go ahead and give a thumbs up. And I'm going to show you some characteristics of the alpha male and how you could actually pick up females. Some of you got a problem with this. You got a serious problem. You try everything. You hate on other guys. Oh, yeah, you go and tell the woman. Oh, yeah, he messed with so-and-so. Because you got henpeck problems, man. So go ahead and give a thumbs up. And classroom is in session, man. I'm about to give you the game. Now, women, I'm going to tell you straight. Women have a variety of tests, right? Especially when it comes to men. And they have a variety of tastes, right? You may be kind of suave smooth, but you may not be kind of dude that a particular woman wants. See, each woman has their own likes and dislikes and guys that they find desirable. Some like the large muscle-bound jocks. Others prefer the thin intellectual types, right? See, a woman's taste can vary over a number of aspects like the physical looks. She might not like a particular race, a particular age, intelligence level, and so on and so forth. But let me give you the game. There is one area, and I should be charging you for this, for real, man. I should be charging you for this because I'm giving you the game right now for free. There's one area that's almost universally attractive to all women. What's that area? That area is a guy's personality. See, if a guy has the right type of personality, he could transcend a lot of the drawbacks and a lot of the other areas, right? You could transcend that. And so that's what this stream is about, showing you how to transcend that, right? Wouldn't you like to know how to do that? Wouldn't you like to know how to transcend these shortcomings that women have? So what am I talking about here? And by the way, if you have not subscribed to my channel, A Spokesman for Men, do so now on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel, A Spokesman for Men, and go ahead and give a thumbs up as you come in the room, right? What I'm trying to teach you today is how to be a high-value alpha male, right? What am I talking about? Well, in my experience, I've learned that women are almost always attracted to what's known as the superior alpha male. You're looking at one, Tazadaq Shaw. See, this type of guy, he embodies all the things that women love. He's masculine. A lot of you don't like me because I'm too damn masculine. You say, well, that guy's too aggressive. You know why? Because you want a feminine, weak, simp beta male. So, but the kind of man that a woman likes, he's masculine, he's confident, And he excludes a high level of sexual compatibility. See, you'll find that displaying the qualities of the superior alpha male can help you become instantly desirable to a wide range of women. So if you want to learn how to be a chick magnet, then keep listening. And by the way, as you come in, go ahead and give a thumbs up. You'll find that what I'm saying is true after you put it to practice, Tyreek Matt. So in this stream, we're going to thoroughly cover the traits that women want from a guy. And if I don't finish it in this one, then I'll do another one. And I don't want to take this too far. Now, I'm not asking you to change who you are. I'm not asking you to do that. But if you've been a simp, hey, it might be time to change. Marty, you know how they be simping, Marty. Guys say that they're being the truth, man. They meet a damn woman, she changes whole damn paradigm. Changes whole damn paradigm. That's a weak. I hate weak dudes, man. That is one thing that gets me upset, man. If I hate damn weak dudes, man, that cater to women. I hate that damn spirit. So I want you to reveal the qualities that you have about yourself as weak and changing. Because what I want to do is to reveal the qualities that are hidden deep within you. And then bring them out whenever you meet women. Point blank, period. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about, Mikael. You know what I'm talking about, Mikael. So primarily, we're going to cover the core personality traits that universally desired by women. And you're going to find that you already possess all of these qualities to some degree. You've just been simping, man. So the hard part is to show them all in a manner that's attractive to women. So now that I've covered the basis, let's find out what Tazadaq's going to teach you, right? Now, you now understand what it means to be a superior alpha male. See, one of the major goals of your life is to develop a naturally attractive personality. In order to do this, you have to understand what women want from a guy. Most of you men don't. Most of you men, truth be told, you was raised by a damn woman, man. So you got a lot of damn feminine characteristics, and you wonder why you can't, you know, even if you meet a woman, you can't hold her. Because you got a lot of feminine characteristics. So in order to do this, you have to understand what women want from a guy. In other words, you have to act in a high status manner every time you meet a new girl. You understand what I'm saying? Know what I'm talking about? So how do you know when you're acting like a high value, superior alpha male? Well, over the last few years, I've studied the personality of men who are the most successful with chicks, right? And what I've found is the majority of those guys have the same handful of personality traits, right? And so by understanding and implementing these traits, you'll create an attitude that's almost all women love. So I'm giving him a game, Marty. I should be charging him for this, man. I'm giving him the game. So we're going to cover those personality traits, man, which are embodiment of a superior alpha male. So as you work on success, you want to heavily concentrate on the personality that you're displaying around women. How do you act around women? You're always catering to her, buying her flowers, sending flowers to a damn drawer, acting like a damn day, Valentine's Day. That's the wrong attitude, man. But you don't have to believe me. Are you running for yourself? See, you'll find that the more you emphasize these qualities, the more attracted you'll become to girls. Why do you be hating on me, man? So some of you come around, your female want to join the damn assembly. You talk her out of it. I don't want your woman. It's not my problem, man, that I have those high value personality traits and you're damn simp beta male. And you hate me for it. So just learn, man. I'm gonna show you how to hold on to your woman and to get one if you don't have one. You understand what I'm saying, Shahab Bey? So what you're gonna find that this process can be a great way to unlock the specific character trait that you need to get these women. So let's get at it. Let's get at it, man. I know you're tired of being a simp beta male. First thing I'm gonna tell you, one of the traits that you gotta have is you gotta have a diverse entrance. See, life isn't all about the money you make. A lot of you simp beta males think you're trying to impress women with money, always buying a crap. Life isn't about the job that you have. You think you get a job, you impress it. You say, I got the job, I still can't get the women. Because you a bard. Life isn't only about having fun. Life isn't about picking up chicks. In this modernized society, it could be a real bitch, man. And right now, society is trying to pull you in a million different directions. And we'll have a different message, right? Becoming thinner by taking super pills. Make a lot of money with proven marketing methods. Stop wasting your life on a boring job. Become more popular with more people you meet. Buy our sneakers to fill the cool fit. They got all kind of marketing lines out there. Life is filled with infinite possibilities. And how you choose to spend your time ultimately determines your success and enjoyment. So the dangers in life and the danger in lies in the time we sacrifice to pursue a desired outcome. When you move through one door and towards a goal, another one closes. So if you're like most men, then you understand that the temptations in life is going to be there. It's really easy to focus solely on one activity and exclude others. Usually this happens when you think that one pursuit will be the outcome that provides the ultimate happiness. Some of you get like this about women, man. You put your whole life in her. See, the truth is spending too much time in a particular activity rarely results in a great life. The guy who really enjoys themselves are the ones who have a variety of interests. I found that guys often spend too much time focusing on one area in their lives. Case in point, right? Let me tell you, I'm going to give you some of the most common pitfalls. Working too much. Some of you work too damn much, right? Exercising too often. You're at the damn gym all of the time. You're damn gym rat. Spending too much time on hobbies and interests. Engaging in relaxing activities like video games. You're a grown-ass man. You're wasting a lot of time on video games, TV watching, and sports. And being too damn social. These are just some of your pitfalls that I'm giving. Everything that I just gave you, these activities are incredibly important. But when you only focus on one of them, your life becomes out of balance. Life should be a combination of all of these pursuits. So you want to be the guy who could work hard and play hard. Having desired entrance isn't only for your benefit. Generally, a guy with a lot going on in his life is somebody who is really attractive to women. You understand what I'm saying? You dig what I'm saying? He has passion about his hobbies. He loves his job. And he has lots of great friends. See, a woman likes these type of guys because she knows he'll provide excitement. She don't want your boring ass. If you're boring, you're a simp beta male. See, remember, you can't spend your time doing one thing and expect that it'll make you attracted to all women. Even if you spend your time working out or practicing seduction material, you'll still have personalities that's not that interesting to the average girl. So even though I recommend you do a number of activities, I still want you to live your life. Don't allow everything else to go to waste. You should work hard on developing your skills. However, you should also make sure that it naturally fits with your pursuits that make you a unique individual. That's what you're going to shoot for. Be a unique individual. Please remember that a woman wants a guy with a variety of interests. That's point one. I need you to remember that. I'm giving them the damn game, Marty. See, a man like this is guaranteed to provide a deep level of intrigue that helps him stand out from the crowd. You got to be dissident. You got to be different. She knows that whatever he's around, she'll enjoy herself. Whenever he's around, she's going to enjoy herself. So the first thing I want you to do, man, all you simp beta males out there, you got a problem picking up women. First thing I want you to do, man, is create your life plan. I'm going to give you a simple exercise, right, that'll help you focus on all the aspects of your life. What you're going to do is list the things that you want from your life. Now, if you're already goal-oriented, if you're already a goal-oriented person, then this task should be easy to complete. On the other hand, if you've never established a list of goals, then you might have to do a bit of creative thinking. So to get started, just simply get out a sheet of paper, find a quiet location, and write down all the things that you want to accomplish in your life. And don't limit or censor what you record. The sky should be the limit. Instead, this is one of those rare moments when you could dream big. Think about all the stuff that you wanted, but made an excuse to put it off. Excuses lead to failure, man. How much money do you want to make? Do you want to retire at a certain age? Is there a certain weight you want to hit? Where do you want to travel? What type of woman do you want to date? What type of relationships do you want your friends or family? Do you have a career goal? Do you have any religious or spiritual goals? See, there's a lot that you could list here, family. But the important thing is to do this exercise in a free-flowing manner. Write them down in a stream of consciousness without worrying about moderating or changing these goals. Just simply write them down. You shouldn't worry if a goal's not attainable in the next few years. This is a wish list for the rest of your life. You might not get to some of these things immediately, but a goal should be recorded in place so that you could actually have time to complete it. And lastly, I recommend that you add to this list every month or so. As your life continues to evolve, you'll find that your viewpoint of the world often changes. And perhaps you'll come to new ideas for how you want to spend your time. That's the first thing you got to do. Now, what's another one of the characteristics of the superior alpha male, Marty Ma? You got to have a purpose. You probably heard that the old age that women want guys with money and power. And if you've actually ever seen Donald Trump, then you know that this is a true statement. Here's a guy with the worst comb over in the world. Yeah, look at the woman that he married. See, if you're like me, then you'll probably realize that she's with him, not because of his looks. So why are so many women attracted to guys like Donald Trump, Mikhail? The answer is going to shock you. The answer is going to shock you, Marty Ma. Why are so many women attracted to guys like Donald Trump? See, most girls are interested in these type of men, not because of their money or their power. They like them because of the things that the money and power represents. A guy with a large amount of financial and powerful resources demonstrates a classic example of high status. I'm trying to teach you to be a high status alpha male. See, women like this type of man because they know he can provide a level of confidence and security that other guys can't offer. This woman's not going to want to be around your broke ass. So throughout history, women look to men for protection and security. I'm giving you the game, man. See, while a lot has changed in the last hundreds of years, women still have this evolutionary need to be with a guy who can actually demonstrate this classic sign of the protector. The protector. And so the best example of this man is a guy with a lot of money or power. So unfortunately, this reality makes a lot of guys really angry. Don't get mad at me, man. Don't get mad at me, Yasha Allah. Some have the viewpoint that any girl who wants a successful guy is acting like a gold digger. But the harsh truth is, the world we live in, getting pissed off because some women prefer guys with money will get you nowhere. It's not going to get you nowhere. You understand? See, the important thing is to remember that wealth and power represents the embodiment of an alpha male. That's what you got to remember. I mean, let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about? Let me give you an example. Say a woman meets two guys with similar looks and personality, right? One is a rich lawyer who drives an expensive Porsche. Tazadaq, push that S550, you know what I mean? The other guy, he works at a local convenience store and he earns $7 an hour. It's only fair that a woman would pick the lawyer because he's able to demonstrate attractive qualities like power and success. So fortunately, there's good news here, though. I'm going to give you the game, man. As I said before, women are attracted to these guys because of the qualities that they display. Traits like power and success are always attracted to women, man. Now, I'm giving you the game, man. I'm telling you what you need, man. That being said, you could demonstrate these qualities without having a fancy job or a large bank account. If you could demonstrate a sense of purpose to your life, this could actually be just as attractive as having a lot of success. The guys who live a sense of purpose naturally draw women into them. What is your purpose? As I mentioned before, all women want passion in their lives. A guy who's going somewhere shows a quality that is very similar to the men with money and power. His passion for life demonstrates he knows what he wants and isn't afraid to go and get it. What does this mean to you? It's simple. If you want a lifestyle where you naturally attract women, you have to find something to be passionate about. Having a purpose to your life. You got to have a purpose besides meeting women. It's a great way to become the kind of guy that women want to meet. You understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about? And there's a catch here. You can't fake passion, man. You can't fake it. Either you're filling your life with stuff that excites you, or you're living a lie. And women can easily detect when guys lack a sense of sincerity to what they're saying. So if you lie about who you are, then your deception will probably be easily discovered. So if you talk about expensive, you know, climbing Mount Everest and so on and so forth, you talking about you got to experience climbing Mount Everest, you better have a few pictures of you at the top of the damn mountain. You understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about? Having a clear vision for your life is something that's attracted to many women. Dig what I'm saying, Kim? In fact, it can easily make up for the lack of money and power. So if you can describe your purpose in an emotional, dynamic manner, it'll be easy to connect to the adventurous side of your personality. The best way to develop a sense of purpose is to establish and complete goals. And since I really know you could do it, I don't know you, but I know you can. I can only take a guess at how you're living your life. You could be a successful guy who has everything he wants in life. However, I would bet that there's a lot of things you still want to do in your life. So let's talk about some goal setting here, right? I'm giving you the game, man. You may not think it's important, Drake, but I'm giving you the game. So when you write down your purpose in a clearly defined manner, it becomes much easier to get it done. For all I know, you might be a person who only knows what he doesn't want in life. That's okay. See, often the best goals come from a place of frustration rather than passion. Case in point, some guys desire financial freedom, not because they want to be rich, but because this signifies that they no longer have to be a part of the rat race of life. The goals you create can be anything that you want out of life. As long as something that you want, then that's the perfect goal. Before I move on to how to create goals, let me clarify one thing, my good brother Marty Mar. Having a sense of purpose and creating goals is not about picking up chicks. Got another exercise for you, man. It can help you get what you want in every aspect of your life. You shouldn't spend your life sitting around for something to happen. If you want something, you should go up and get after it. Get up and go after it. See, while having a passion for life is a great way to attract women, I think this is something you should do for yourself. So, second thing I'm going to teach you, man, establish your goals. First exercise I gave you, you created a wish list of the things you want to achieve in life. This exercise, you list your goals. See, if you do this exercise, you capture a whole bunch of ideas, things you want to eventually do. Some items could be done this year. Others might take you 20 plus years to achieve. The problem is that this list is completely random. It contains a list of what you want to do, but nothing about how you could get them done. But with this particular exercise right here, we're going to take this wish list and turn it into a series of goals. What are your goals in life? To get started, you need to create a concrete plan for how turning these dreams into reality. Remember, women are attracted to guys living their purpose. What is your purpose? They don't want dreamers. They want guys who is passionately moving towards his meaning in life. Do you understand? Do you understand? So I want you to take this wish list and turn it into a list of actionable items that you'll move towards your goals. First, you want to take this list and separate the goals into long-term and short-term goals. Some items won't be achieved in the next few years, so they should be on your long-term list. Other goals can easily be done in the next few weeks or years. So you have to put them in the short-term category. And so the next thing I want you to do is to break down these goals into specific categories. Career, personal development, travel, fitness, health, relationship, family, athletics, and so on and so forth. Spiritual, finance. And after you classified your goals, you want to concentrate on the ones that are the most important to you. These are the ones that will bring the greatest amount of success and happiness to you within the next couple years. Do you understand? Talk about, what does this have to be do with being successful with women? Everything. It's making you goal-oriented, giving you a purpose in life. Third thing I'm going to tell you is to be passionate. I talked about passion a little earlier, right? So in regards to your sense of purpose now, I want to move on to something similar. Women are highly attracted to guys who have a passion for life. One of my closest friends, right? He's smooth with birds, right? Over the last few years, I've watched him take his life's ambition and turn it into a thriving business. Instead of following the traditional route and going to work for a company, he followed his dreams. I'm talking about Tazadaq. And the risk paid off. Now, the interesting thing about Tazadaq is how easily it is for him to attract birds. See, before he found his current rib, he would always have a new story about a random chick hitting him up. Most of the time, they would contact him through email or something like that and talk about how they want to meet him, sleep with him, and so on and so forth. I'm giving you the game, man, Drake. I can't make this up. And during my days of not getting women, the accent of these girls really puzzled me, right? Tazadaq wouldn't do anything, wouldn't do any work, yet he still had his pick of women. And as I stated, working on this area, and started working on this area in my life, I came to realize why my friend Tazadaq was so successful. One of the key ingredients to his success in life and women was the high level of passion. If you notice, Tazadaq is very passionate about his teaching. If you hang out with him for more than 5 minutes, you will see a great example of a guy who has a variety of interests and hobbies. Whenever he talks about his activities and artwork, he subconsciously displays many of the qualities that women find attractive. Rather than being concerned with getting laid, Tazadaq simply enjoys life. You know what I'm talking about? See, women are joined to guys with a passion for life. In a substantial manner, this type of guy, this type of man displays a sense of purpose that's enticing to the average woman. In a way, she knows that a guy who is passionate about everything will probably be an exciting, fun person to be around. Being passionate is about finding the excitement in any situation. See, it's all about how you talk to yourself. The words you use have a major impact on how you're perceived. By finding the fun in any situation, you'll display a personality that women want from a guy. You know what I'm talking about? A very simple but very effective way to show passion is to embrace the awesomeness of any situation. Even if you find yourself in a boring or dull environment, think to yourself about what is great about this moment. Case in point, let's pretend you're on a long train ride to work. Instead of having a mindset of boarding, you look for the advantage of being on the train. Perhaps you will come to the realization that it's an excellent opportunity to meet new women. Remember the words that you use. Your self-talk will ultimately determine your outcome. When you look for the excitement in any situation, you'll train yourself to become a more positive, fun person to be around. And this will help becoming more naturally attractive guy to women. So you got to find out what's your passion in life, King. What's your passion? And the fourth thing I'm going to tell you is to be attracted to yourself. I don't want this to last too long. I've been talking for a minute here. I've been talking for 35 minutes. I'll go with this one real quick. Next thing I'm going to tell you is to be attracted to yourself, man. Your belief system will ultimately determine your long-term success with women. In other words, a lot of what you could do with your life hinge on what you think, about. So if you believe that you're an interesting, attractive guy, then you'll display a confident attitude that's attracted to women. No matter what, you must love yourself. I know this sounds ironic, right? But you must love yourself. Loving yourself is one of those keys to being attracted to women. So as you're probably aware of, women are incredibly gifted at detecting our body language, right? They can easily sense when a guy has a sense of no confidence in his looks. See, being attracted to yourself simply means fixing what you can. Then learning to accept the things beyond your control. We all have our physical limitations. Some are pretty major, while others aren't that important, right? The truly attracted guy is somebody who loves himself regardless of his physical flaws. If you project a comfortable attitude, women will be attracted to you no matter what you look like. This is why you have this ugly dude, man, and you got a bad chick. And there's one more important point I want to make here. If you're obese, you shouldn't simply accept this flaw and be happy with your looks. If you're fat, you're fat. You need to get your fat ass on a treadmill and lose some weight, man. What I want you to understand is you should always try to improve all aspects in your life, but not to the point where you hate the way that you look. See, I'm a firm believer in constant improvement. This means that you should work on losing that weight. If you're fat. You know what I'm talking about? Now, if you're a Simp Beta male, there's a lot of Simp Beta males out there, right? And they change for women, man. Simp Beta male, he be hanging out with the crew, whatever. And all of a sudden, he starts to move funny, Marty. You know what I'm talking about, Marty? You know, we're thinking everything's together. You know, everybody's on point, Marty Ma. Damn, Simp Beta male, he meet a new woman, boom, he's gone. He's gone. You know what I'm talking about, Marty? We've seen him. We've seen it like a zenith. We see it right now. Brother's missing in action. I hate a weak dude like that, man. Hate a weak dude like that. Celebrating Christmas, trying to call himself an Israelite. Some of you celebrating Christmas today, man. You're hanging out with your damn girl, man. Exchanging gifts. You think we don't know that, man? You're a Simp Beta male. You're trying to cater to that woman, man. And she broke your ass down, man. You realize, yeah, I was talking to a dude today, man. He went into straight simp mode, man. He found out that, you know, this chick was cheating on him with three other dudes. I had to tell him straight, yo, you had a hoe, man. You trying to turn into a housewife. You can't do that. What does he do? He hits her. That's why she won him, man. Come on, man. You guys got to stop simping. You got to stop simping, man. You get your feelings all according to this woman, man. She throw the vajay on you. She do every damn thing. You think you're special. She tell you all of these things. You thinking you're special. Negro, you ain't special. You know what I mean, guys? She said that too. You better get your mind right, kid. You better try that spirit. But you're weak, which is why you cater to her. This is why a lot of you not coming around now, man. You weak ass, man. You're simp. You let a woman break you down. Like, I don't have no respect for a man like that. I can't respect a dude like that, man. You let a woman break you down. That's weak, man. That's not no alpha male. You let a woman break you down, change your mind state. You stop coming around, talking about what you fighting. Get your weak ass up out of here. Because I don't like dudes like that. I don't want them around me, man. Can't respect simp beta males, man. And a lot of you, you be coming on these calls, man, when I do these videos, man. You're fake too, man. I see you. I see right through you. All you do all of this stuff, man, to attract women, man. And you come on the channel, you talk about them because you couldn't have the success with them that you wanted. You do this, anything you do to attract a woman, man. But you come over here, you try and talk like, you know, you down. You ain't really down, man. I can see right through fake people. You're fake. You be hard body, you know, up around us until you meet a woman. You meet a woman and you start disappearing, slowly disappearing. You come on down calls. You don't even say anything anymore. You're weak ass, man. That's who you really are. You're exposing yourself for who you really are, man. The true spirit really comes out. So it takes a damn woman to break your ass down, man. You weak. I can't respect no man like that. But you're going to learn in the end, man. You come back at him and spit in your damn face. Not playing, man. I don't like no damn weak men. I don't like that damn spirit around me, man. I'm not going to allow you to put that spirit on me or anyone that's affiliated with me, man. You're sent, man. You talk real tough until you put to the test. Then you put to the test, E, break your ass down. You're sent. But I understand who you are, man. You're supposed to be man in the image and likeness of the creator. But a woman will break you down. And the more attracted you think she are, the weaker your behind become. I don't respect none of you men like that. Because at the end of the day, she's just a woman. And you better listen to what I'm saying, man. I'm trying to teach you to be a damn man. And I'm going to hit you something, man. Most of you damn guys are like this. Is you guys that's been raised by these single women, man. These single mothers, you don't know how to be a damn man. I don't give a damn you wrestle, whatever, man, you've been through. You don't know how to be a damn man, man. You're weak. You're weak, man. You don't know how to be a damn man. You're trying to make excuses, man. A lot of you was raised by these damn single women, man. That's why you're so bitchy and like to argue a lot. Time to stop simping, man. You're trying to act like a pimp, but we see you. We see that you're a simp. You just lie, and I see right through you, man. And this is why I call so many of you out. You can't even concentrate on the Most High's work, man. Women lure you away. And you're weak ass talking about you dealing with demons, man. You're weak from the start. It's amazing, man. Like I told you, Marty, the Negro is an amazing, astonishing, idiotic, dumbfounded creature. Never cease to amaze me. Every time I think I got the up and up on a damn Negro, he does something that's totally, I don't know, asinine. And some of you other ones, man, you come on here talking about, you trying to front like you so smooth with these women, man. You ain't no damn better, man. I respect, I'm going to tell you, man, I respect the dude that, he's a simp beta male. He come clean with it. Then one of you that come on here and fake. Like you so tough, man. Then you get with a chick and she blow your damn mind, man. Like C4 or something. You dig what I'm saying, Marty? You don't pick up your phones or nothing anymore, man. Even blew your damn mind, man. And this system, man, you men better wake up, man. This brother that I'm talking about, when he found out that this bard was cheating on him with three different guys, he hit her. They got his ass now, man. You don't want to get to that status, man. When you got to get to a point where you feel like you got to put your hands on her, man, you got to leave that, man. It's not worth it. That's simping. You getting your feelings all caught up in something where it shouldn't be at. Too many of you men, man, you got that damn effeminate energy. You got to beat her. You don't need her. You don't need her, man. You work on yourself, man. You stay focused on your purpose, man. What is your mission in life, man? If you stay focused on your purpose, women are going to come, man. Women are going to come. Don't worry about these damn women. They're going to come. And you got to know which ones are used for a damn pump and dump. Boom, boom. Bye, bitch. And keep it moving. You fall all in love, man. You buying flowers. You run out to the store. Sending her flowers at a damn drawer. You weak, sip, bait a damn mouth. And you find out someone else is blowing her back out at work. Because a lot of these chicks be having dudes at work, man. Dig what I'm saying, Kings? I'm trying to give you right knowledge for real, man. This is right knowledge for real. I tried to told you, Drake. How do I become a part of the T-Dot camp? Hey, Drake, send your, just email your number and photo to Tazadaq Shah. Email your location. Drake, email your location, your phone number and photo to that email address right there, tazadaqshah@yahoo.com. That's how you become a part of T-Doc camp. But you can't be no simp. If you're trying to come in as a simp, man, we're gonna tie you to a stake, man, have General Yashabin just pound on you until he get tired. So I'm gonna go ahead and post the link in the room, man. Anyone wanna come in and say something, man? Anyone come in here and say something? Marty, I know you got something to say, Marty. Talk that talk, man. What you say about these simps, man? Marty, I keep hearing these bad stories, man, about men that keep getting... Men just keep getting done, man. How do they keep... Man, this brother... I kind of felt sorry for the brother. I just was coaching him earlier, man. Brother punched in the face, man. I'm not going to put your name out there, brother, man, but you... That was a whole move right there, man. You don't get caught up in no feelings like that. Now you're going to catch a case behind that. They try and prosecute him beyond that, man. I'm telling you, brothers, man, walk away. You got to let a garden tool be a garden tool, man. And I'm not talking about no shovel, man. I'm talking about a hoe. Got him now, man. Anyone that want to come in here, the link is in the room. Speak on it. And it's a damn shame if any of you got them Christmas trees up today, man. I feel sorry for you. I'm going to have my man come on and do a testimony, man, of the live streams. And I'm going to tell you something, man. All of you under the sounds of my voice right now, you need to sign up for the webinar tomorrow, man. One brother, he attended the webinar, and he just discharged $30,000 in debt by doing the EFT that he learned at one of my webinars. And the brother's going to do a testimony. I'm trying to get him to do it today, the brother Ephraim. I'll see if he could do it today around 3:30. Brother Discharge, Marty Ma knew it. Marty Ma heard his testimony. Am I lying, Marty Ma? The brother told us yesterday he discharged $30,000 in debt, man, using an EFT.
Using an EFT, he got it done, man. No, with ease, he said, with ease. After he grabbed up this knowledge from the Khan, you know, you got to get with that.
And this was a major company, man. One of these major corporations. Brother got it done, man.
Got it done, man, for real.
Yeah, that's the right email. But I mean, Marty, I mean, what do you think, man? These guys, this guy, I talked to a guy this morning. I was coaching him. And he found out she's having sex with three different guys. How in the hell he didn't know that, Marty? She having sex with three different guys, and he meet her at a location. And I guess, you know, it hurt him so bad, he holds off and punch her. Then she got him on charges.
See, that's a sucker there, man. See, you can't be getting caught up like that, man.
And she has glasses on. She had glasses on, Marty, so they charging him with assault with a deadly weapon.
Let me tell you something. These cats know when these brides is moving like that, man. Tell me you don't know. A dude know when his chick is getting dealt with on the side, man. He know He know when his woman is hitting a miss on the side, man. I wish a fucking bride would come to me with that, man. You know that nonsense. I throw ass out, man, on the fucking curb, man.
Hey, my money. He got in his feelings though, man. He got in his feelings, man. He hauled off and he punched in the face, man.
Nah, you don't do that, man. You don't. I mean, you don't put your hands on nobody, man. You know, you don't put your.
Yeah, man, you walk away from that.
Turn your back on that, man, like a bad dream, man.
And the brother, he just wasn't getting it. I was like, yo, man, you know what I mean? I told him, I said, yo, man, she had to give you some kind of indication, brother, that something was going on. You knew something. He's like, yeah, man, I should have just went with my And Marty, he punched her so damn hard, it was blood on her damn glasses. Now they doing a damn DNA. You know what I mean?
Yes,
they're gonna try and hit him hard. This is a pretty good brother too, man.
Check this out. Check this out, Khan. You know what's gonna happen now? Now she got lights and she gonna turn it up. Everybody gonna be hitting that while he's upside down. While he's locked up on the ropes, everybody is gonna be taxing that ass, boy. They're gonna be getting that, man.
Damn, come on.
You know I'm telling the truth.
Come on, Marty, man. You're the dude, man. The dude might be listening now, man.
That's too bad, man. You need to hear this, man. You know, because I, you know, they get mad at
me. Come on, Marty, man. Come on, man.
That's what's up, man.
Come on, man. You're hurting the brother, Marty. Come on, man. It's a good dude, Marty.
That's all right, man. That's all right.
I'll make you something, Marty. Hey, Marty, I'm going to hit you with something now. It's the same kind of case that I always talk about. The brother wasn't raised by his father. His father wasn't in his life. Right there. Anyone that's asking how to get to the webinar, right here. I just posted the information in the room. Yeah, he didn't have his father in his life, Marty. So anyone that wants to register for the webinar, someone just ask, click on that link and go ahead and register. Make sure you don't register under no business name. If you do, you're not going to attend. Yeah, that was another case of a man not having his father in his life, Marty.
Hey, you know what, man? These dudes, they got to realize this, man. If you keep that spirit on you, you deserve it, man. These women, man, they come with all that. They ain't at the fucking store. Bro, I've been at the store all day and come back with not a damn thing. That's what happens, man. That's what happens. These birds go out, stay out all day. I've been shopping, come back. and baby, what you get? Not shit. That's what happens, man. You got to remove that spirit, man. You never be a top flight. You never be a top flight brother at the top of your game if you're gonna keep on sipping. Meant for them. It's made for them. We're gonna put a label on it. Bottle it, put it in the store, and all the sip. You deserve it. Tony. That's what's up. Sip juice is made for suckers. They get mad at me all the time, Con, for talking real talk, man. But I don't give a damn if they get mad at me. Get mad all you want.
Let them get mad, Marty.
Marty, keep it real, Marty. Marty Marr lived real good. He lived like a fuck. I keep it first class. Don't get it wrong. I'm a respectful cat, man. When I move with my little pebbles, that's how we get down. Actually, I got a couple of pebbles, but I can do it. That's how I move, you know. See, these women ain't running nothing, man. They need to hear that. They need to sit their ass down and stop all that nonsense they do. Acting stupid, talking out the side of their neck, talking out flipping, popping their neck side to side. The Most High didn't mean for your dumb ass to act like that. Get back in the spirit, you stupid ass drive. Now, and if you don't like it so damn much, I've been mad at before, but I tell you one thing. Do I care? No, I don't give a damn. Give a damn. Man, that's how I move, you know. I'm always moved like that. That's how I get down, and I always have success in what I do. I'm a successful dude, man. And just like I follow his doctrine because he dropped it. If you don't understand that, he's looking out for it. You know, this is the real deal shit, man. He trying to make you be a man first and all that, because see, most of you listen to your woman.
You're blanking out, Marty.
Okay, I'm just saying, you know, they need to get with this real truth, man. You know, it ain't all good.
Yeah, Marty, a lot of them, I mean, they don't want it, man. They don't want it, Marty. They can't handle the truth, Marty. You already know. They can't handle the real truth, Marty.
And they can't get with this, man. You know, you got to be real with this guy, man. Admit it. Accept it. And this will all work for you, because first you got to work on yourself. And oneself, you got to realize, if you got Eve all up over you like a cheap suit, peel that bride off and put on, man, something real classy, man. Put on something befitting you. Go to a tailor. Get tailor-made for one of these little pebbles like Marty Marr get down, you know. Get tailor-made for a real woman, you know, because they out there. You ain't got to settle for no broad popping a neck, twerking on the corner at the club, come up missing at the store.
But they know this though, Marty. These dudes be knowing this, man. That, man, so, like I told the brother, man, I said, come on, Art. You punched her in the face and broke her glasses. they found blood on her glasses, Marty. And I said, come on, man, this whole, you know what I mean? She not just one dude, Marty. She's cheating. He found out she messing with three dudes. Are you getting upset over that? Huh?
That's a doorknob, Ock. That's a doorknob. Everybody get a turn at that, man.
Come on.
You dig? I said it, you know, I don't give a damn. I know these Eves don't like me. Oh, that he's just like the kahan. He talks, no, I'm not just like the kahan. I'm not just like the kahan. The kahan, he surrounds himself by real men, not no square ass sucker.
Hey, but I hit you with something, Marty. At the end of the day, man, they respect you for it, man. They respect you for it. Even though they don't even say it, they respect you for it, man.
I'll keep it first class over here, man. Shit. But what he's really trying to do is shoot you some love and some respect. All the brothers under the sound of our voice right now, we trying to give you something. We ain't just talking crazy. This real talk, man. Peel these heat back, man. You ain't got to put your hands on them. And you ain't got to stand up for the block, hey, come up missing all day either.
Hey, what the hell you want to hit it for, man? You know what I mean? Just be a man and walk away, man. You know, when you feel like you got to put a hand, your hands on a Marty, you weak Simp Beta male behind, man. She knows she got you, man. She probably, oh, this nigga want to fight over me. He want to beat me. She see that as love, man.
Sucker, that's sucker stuff, man. Well, go ahead, Nico Panaya. What's up there, young brother?
Hey, shalom, shalom.
Shalom, young brother.
Elder Marty Mar, no, I needed today's message. I've been kind of, not kind of, I've just been, like you said, I had the woman draped up on me for too long, taking a lot of my energy, and I have been straying away from reading the scriptures and being where I need to be and staying on my mission and my goals, so. I needed today's message. It's like a slap in the face. I needed it. So I'm just here listening.
Yeah, this dude.
We love you, brother.
This dude, Marty, this dude holds off and punch her in the face. And I'm just like, yo, brother, I can't lie. You know what I mean? I can't. I said, did you do it? And he like, yeah. Well, brother, you got to, you know what I mean? The consequences. So I was like, did she hit you? Yeah, she hit me. So you responded, natural instinct, you know what I mean? But why didn't you bring it? I'm gonna show you how these damn Simp Beta males be doing, right? He didn't even bring no charges against her. Now she's trying to prosecute him to the fullest. Now he hit her with glasses on, Marty. She got blood on her glasses. You understand? That's how these Eves are, man. Hey, now she's trying to crucify him. She's trying to put him... She's trying to put his ass on a stake, Marty.
Son, she gonna be soon as he get locked up, man. They have him pressed out, man, on the slabs in the big house. Everybody in town gonna be blowing through that.
I mean,
man.
They already been doing it with him, you know what I mean? And he was like talking about his on and off. He said the relationship's been on and off. I'm like, damn, brother, why you think it's on and off? Because she's with them other dudes and she's not with you. You dig what I'm saying?
Did.
He's like, yeah, man, you're right. I was like, yeah, but I don't want to hear that I'm right, brother. This woman gave you some kind of indication that something was off, man. She gave you some kind of indication that something wasn't right, but you ignored it. He's like, yeah, man, you're right, man. I just thought I could, because, you know, they would get together, break up, get together. Come on, man, what you think's going on? The way that Eve is in this day and time, man, she was someone else, Marty. You understand what I'm saying? It's just how they are, man. Their mothers are raising them that way, man.
Check this out. I'm going to tell you right now, Marty Mar ain't no square. And we all been down the path of unrighteousness at some point. But I'm going to keep it real. If you, a real man, look into your relationship, man, with a microscopic mind and see what you're being faced with, man. Because these Eves, if you don't have the right spirit on you, you will not be successful in life. You will be wasting all kinds of time. So it's all for your own good. When you pick a woman, you should be picking a woman that you plan to spend the rest of your life with. I'm telling you straight up. You should be planning and picking and choosing in a real way. But it's not about Because I'm going to tell you, if she's quick to peel that rap back, if she's pulling that rap back, she's pulling it back, not just for you, for everybody. That's how they get down. That's what's up, man.
And they will lie right to your face, Marty, man. It's hard. I'm telling you, man. A good woman is hard to find in this society, man. They turn our women into harlots, man. And they think it's okay. You know what the woman's mind? If he do it, I could do it too. But the Most High is going to bring judgment against that mindset, man. Can't do it, man. Yashabim in the background. Mikael, what you got to say about all of this, man? Neil Stewart. What you got to say about this, Neil Stewart? Come on in here, man. Talk that talk. By the way, man, 3:30, I'm going to have a brother come on, do a confession about discharging over $30,000 in debt after attending one of my webinars. He used the EFT method. Brother Ephraim. Marty Mar, you still there?
Kahan. I'm still here, Kahan. Reaching out. We're reaching out to these brothers big time, man. They think this is just talking shit, man. This needs to be said, man. This needs to come out, man. See, everything you do and say is about something, man. The Eve you pick is a reflection directly upon oneself.
There's no way. Let me tell you something, Marty. There's no way I could get with a woman that's not in this truth. If I'm talking to some woman and I introduce it to her and she rejects that, I can't deal with her, man. Because you got a wicked woman right there. The only thing you could use her for is a pump and dump. And we're not supposed to be doing that in the truth, man. We go and lay with her. We got an obligation to her. Eric White, what you got to say about this? You real mellow with this stuff, Eric White. Eric White, he doesn't say much about these kind of topics. Yashabim, come on in here and say something, man.
Everybody feel the way they feel.
What you got to say, Dwayne? You laughing, man. What's so funny, Dwayne? You come on in here too, Dwayne. Sharon Jackson. Come on in here, Sharon. You say this is not a one-sided issue. Come on in. Come on in, Sharon Jackson. You said it's not a one-sided issue. Come on in and speak up. All of you putting messages in the chat room, come on in and speak up. There's a link right there. Come on in and speak up. Stop talking in the chat and say it on Viva Voce. Yeah, man. We see you, Benai. We see all of these guys, man, that's falling back, man. Most I never let anything pass by me, man. Just got to be strong, man. Endure. Yashabim, you come on over here, man. I hope you ain't celebrating reindeers fly in the sky, man. Eric White. Come on over here, Eric White. You be kind of too quiet, man. When we talk about these social things right here. Aquarius, you fell right back out. What you got to say about this, Dwayne? You can come on too, Drake.
Shalom, shalom.
Shalom. What you got to say about this, Dwayne? What do you think about all this going on, man? Brothers falling out. Brothers don't come around. It's amazing, man. You know what I call it, Dwayne? Pussy Negro problems.
Simping ain't easy.
Actually it is. Simping is really easy. That's why so many people fall into that mold, man. It's amazing, man, what women could do to men, man. Wow. The power they have over men.
I was raised in a household where my father was not my biological father, but my stepfather was around, and he was pretty stern and rigid. So right. I feel like I have that experience of being, you know, raised with a family where family matters and, you know, maintaining your role in the position matters. My mother was pretty much a housewife. She stayed home, taught the kids how to, you know, just raised us pretty much. And she encouraged the same thing. She would, like Marty Marr brought out earlier, you know, when you, whether you are Eve or Jake, if you're looking for someone, you should look to look for marriage. You know, you're not looking to just go have a, you know, one night fling or hook up or be girlfriend and boyfriend. Like, you're looking for a wife or a husband. So if that intention isn't in the back of your head, you're going to attract everything else. And, you know, I'm not going to lie. I would say up until like the last 3 years, I was behaving, you know, like a simp in certain areas of life. And just to keep it brief, I decided to get my ducks in a row financially and economically, you know, starting my journey, becoming a creditor, and then also getting my mind right spiritually. Because, you know, if you got the finance, but you don't got the spirit to back that up, she gonna run all over you. She gonna make you punch her in the face and then take your money, et cetera.
That's what he did. That's what his brother did. You're saying that, but this brother literally did that.
That's he why literally I said punched it. Yeah,
her in the face, man, and broke her glasses and got blood all over her glasses. And then they're testing the DNA because he said he didn't do it.
That's wild, Doc.
So, man, what the hell was you thinking, man? Why didn't you just walk away? Yeah, I don't know, man. I just reacted. That's emotional, brother. That's what I be talking about.
Con. Yeah, and like that effeminate spirit on men is real. It's real. I mean, like 9 out of 10 dudes that I come across are always talking about, damn, look at that booty. Damn, I'll eat that. But bro, like she been with like 8 other dudes. I don't care. She can get it. And I'm just like, that's disgusting. That's dirty, you know? Whenever I go out in the public, you know, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. You know, if I go to the store, I'm going to grab groceries. I ain't going out to like, you know, go flirt with women and et cetera, et cetera. But, you know, women with their dudes, I'm not gonna say I'm like a great looking dude, but they be peeping, you know, they be having their roving eyes, et cetera, et cetera. And as has been brought out earlier at the workplace, Eve's got work husbands, Jake's got work wives, and they like to play in those roles and like take it further than what it needs to be. And it's just wickedness, you know, and you got to really keep your head down, stay in your lane and just pray and, you know, keep doing what you got to do. You're going to attract it. It's going to come to you both sides.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Humble servant, what you got, man? You saying, yeah. Well, all of you in the room talking in the background, come on in the chat, man. Come on in the chat and speak on it. What is that? Sharon Jackson. Come on in and speak. Or keep your mouth closed if all you want to do is put something in the chat board, man. Hey, Akwaj, what you got?
Hey, Shalom. Can I be heard?
Yeah, come.
Yeah, I came in on the middle of this call, and I heard what you were saying, man. I just listened to the words of wisdom, man. Thank you for that, man. I was typing up this conditional acceptance and all that. But situation with the brother putting his hands on that harlot, man, that's a super beta male simp man Jana move right there, man.
Mm-hmm.
Cause that in itself shows that you got a scarcity mindset, man, because there's so many different, a plethora of women out here, man. And to think that, you know, you're going to put your hands on somebody because they're sleeping around, that's not going to stop them from sleeping around. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, she could have provoked that. Like, I'm not saying she deserved to get hit. I'm not advocating for that. But she could have probably wanted, she probably been doing, like you said, there were signs. She probably been blatantly disrespecting him to his face, to the point where she's like, this simp is not, he's not getting the signs. Like, I don't answer his phone calls, I don't respond to his texts. I'll be telling him my phone battery is dead, damn well knowing that I got multiple chargers, and, you know, he can't believe that. You know, when he hitting the box probably don't even feel right. Like, it don't even feel the same from when he was hitting it before. So you got to know what's going on, bro. Like I'm gonna speak from experience of being a beta male simp man Johnny myself. You know, after a while, like, the sex ain't the same, man. Let's keep it a buck. You know what I'm saying? She's not, you know, she's not wanting to tend to her duties. She's not, you know, like I said, respond to a phone call. She's not wanting to cook, clean, you know what I'm saying? Things of that nature. She's always, you know, starting fight, arguing. A big red flag is when she's telling you, let's take a break. Like the brother said.
Right.
Yeah. The brother said they done broke up like 2-3 times already. And you see the thing, this is why the scriptures is such a beautiful thing, man, because the scriptures tells you that sex is marriage, man. So this girlfriend, boyfriend stuff, that stuff is non-existent, man. It's either you together or you not. Like we don't play this boyfriend, girlfriend, I'm gonna break up with you because of this, or she talked too much, I'm gonna break up with her, or you know, he not listening to me, so I'm gonna break up with him, this, that, and the third. And then now you go run off, she go run off with Tom, Dick, and Harry, you know, and then talk about she wanna come back to you like a couple weeks later because Tom, Dick, and Harry pumped and dumped it and then kept it moving. So now she's gonna jump back to you. Meanwhile, you know, you're not realizing what she was doing, and Tom, he got herpes. So he done gave us some herpes, and then now she bringing it back to you, and then now it's a whole mess, man. So, you know, I don't really know what the detailed situation is, but to have to put your hands on her, man, that's especially in this type of time. Like, I wouldn't want anybody to go to prison, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't wish that on my enemy like that, you know what I'm saying? But, at this type of time, to put your hands on her, bro, that's, I don't even feel sorry for him, to be honest, bro. Like, I know you said you feel sorry, Taz, and I could understand the compassion, but bro, like, you had to know, she was up to no good, brother. Like, you know what I mean? I'm sorry the situation transpired, but you had to be wiser than that, Ken. Gotta be wiser than that. But, in terms of the overall message, man, just stay focused on your goals, man. Like, I can't even tell you, man. Like, brothers be chasing these Eves around, man. Just focus on your purpose, on your mission, and, you know, if you build it up, they will come, man. You know? Yep. But the main thing is that, you know, the ones that do come, you know, are these quality women. Because, you know, I get a lot of, I get chose on all the time by these women, but are they quality women that I could see myself, planting in that soil, putting a seed in that soil and raising up another son or daughter or whatever, daughter of Zion or whatever the case is, you know, are they quality women? That's the thing, man. So, you know, that's the main thing. And as far as I can see, over 90% of them are not quality women, you know, so. It would make more sense to focus on your purpose, and if the Most High bless you with that, you know, you get that. So that's all I really want to say on that. That matter.
Yeah. You know what's crazy though? Is that brother told me she called them out of the blue, and she said, "I want to talk about what happened," and it turns out she had Norks on the phone in the background listening to the conversation, trying to get him to confess to hitting her. But where he told me she hit him first. And so he, you know, he responded. I was like, well, why didn't you file charges or what have you? So I just didn't, man. So all right, man, come on. Now they testing the DNA because he said he didn't do it. So they waiting for the DNA to come back on the glasses. So they trying to charge him with using a deadly weapon against her because when he hit her, she had the glasses on. So they trying to say the glasses was a deadly weapon.
That's crazy.
That's how these damn attorneys are, man.
Crazy.
That's how these damn attorneys are. Yeah, man.
But he's like I was just saying, she probably set that whole situation up. Like, listen, I've been running around on this Negro for the longest. He's not taking a hint. So you know what? Let me start a fight. Cause Eve will get like that. Like for me, I can have a regular quiet day routine, do what I gotta do. You know what I'm saying? It might seem boring to most people, but you know what I mean? It's my routine. But I'm not going to say all, but vast majority of Eves, they have to have some kind of chaos in their life. Nothing could just go linear. It can't just go straight. There has to be some kind of yelling, screaming, surprise, happiness, sadness. There has to be, you know what I'm saying? So she must have been like, let me start something up. And you know what I'm saying? Being that he's a beta male simp mangina, his reaction's probably gonna go, you know, to my advantage. And that's what happened. Because he hit her back, you know what I'm saying? She damn well know that the courts is gonna take her sides. You know what I'm saying? Even if he didn't hit her, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's right, chewing.
Yeah. Yeah, so the courts is gonna be in her favor, you know what I'm saying? Most high forbid, like, I don't know the situation in depth, like, but if they got kids together, if they got property together, if they got a business together, oh, he's screwed. He's screwed. Because they're gonna try to, you know, divvy that up real nice. You know.
Yeah, he didn't mention anything about any children or anything like that, but I don't know, man.
The brother should get tested too, man. Because I don't know if he was, you know, raw pickling that or whatever the case is, but should definitely get tested in the meantime, man. You know. But, hey, man, simping is a sickness, man. People got to get well. You know, so.
Yeah, it's a growing trend, man.
It is, but at the same time, with all this knowledge out here, man, you know, the so-called powers that be are trying to ban this type of red pill information because, like, I don't know if you ever heard of Twitch, but it's like another platform for alternative to YouTube. On Twitch, they banned people from using the word simp over there because. Yeah, they banning people for using it, but it's not really to protect men, like. When you look at the undertones behind a lot of this stuff, it's not to protect the men. At the end of the day, it's because the women are using the Twitch just like as they would use OnlyFans. So Twitch is able to eat off of those. It's almost kind of like a pimp service. They're able to eat off those profiles. So if you have, you know, somebody donating to Twitch and other men see them, yo, you just took your paycheck and you contributed to this Twitch profile XYZ, you a simp. So the next man putting the next man onto red pill game, you know what I'm saying? And Twitch can't have that because they harlots, their whores can't, you know, really, you know, make bank off of the simps like that. So now they have to start negating certain words and stuff. So yeah
man, that's crazy that they're trying to ban the word, man. These social media platforms are out of control.
Yeah. I don't know if you got the text I sent you out of one. I sent you a link to another station for podcasts called Anchor, where you could monetize your podcast. It's pretty much, you know, for up and coming people who want to have like podcast stations and stuff like that. And it's not overly you know, regulated like YouTube is.
Can you do videos on there? Just audio?
Just audio out of one. It's just on podcasts.
Alright.
Yeah. So that might be something you want to look into. I'm looking to myself as well because I could with that platform I could link my music, my Spotify music, with the Anchor. So I might use them both. But in any event, you know yeah, the main thing, man, just gotta stay focused, man. Gotta stay focused on your purpose, you know. Cause, like, I don't know. I don't want to gas myself up at all. But I've noticed in my experience, I don't know if it's because I'm focusing more on my purpose or if it's the so-called the pandemic, why a lot of Eves or maybe it's the location from changing from the location I was in. A lot of Eves are gravitating towards me more, you know what I'm saying? But I just think it is, you know, you just got to focus on your purpose. If you're more or less focused on getting this woman, that woman, and, you know, stuff like that, it's fun at first, but the end result is never good. It's never advantageous, man. My experience. But hey, that's all I want to say, King.
Yeah, all right, man.
The water for having me on the show.
Sharon, what you got? Sharon's pretending she don't know how to get into the chat. I'm gonna post the link again, Sharon. You click on this link right here. Under the name Tazadaq, a spokesman for men and all of that. Show her how to get in the room, Mikael. Click on that link, Sharon. Humble servant, what you got? I saw Yasha being more here with his Applejack one, man. But he didn't come in the room. Mikael, show Sharon how to get in the room, man. Click on that link, Sharon. You know how to get in here. Sharon Jackson, click on that link to come in the room. Shalom, what's going on, Trading War Stories? What's going on, Mikael?
Shalom, 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 family. Everybody on the panel, shalom.
Shalom.
I hear you doing your thing, Kahan. It's never a dull moment. Always something going on. And, you know, I just got out the tank.
Jackson, click on that link to come in the room. Sharon, mute your YouTube, Sharon. Your feedback's coming through.
What's going on, Mikael? Hello?
Yeah, Sharon, your YouTube got to be muted. We're getting feedback from you. Hey, go ahead, Mikael. Oh, hold on a second, Sharon. You got to mute that YouTube in the background. You hear that, Sharon? That's your YouTube. You gotta mute your YouTube and talk through your stream.
How do I do that?
You just simply click mute on the YouTube channel.
Okay.
Yeah, it's muted now. All right, you're good now.
Con. You know I'm in the chat. I'm seeing, you know, couple fellas came through. They sound like, you know, they I don't know what brought them here on a day like today, you know, the pagan festival,
right?
Krampus, you know, and their Eve is definitely in the back seat somewhere. You know, these Eves, they like to drive from the back seat, dictate where you go. But, you know, if you want that, you can. That's the mindset you have, is if you want it. Because at the end of the day, you make the decisions as a man. You stand on your square. You stand on your platform. And you know what? To be honest, women are not going to satisfy.
Mikael, look at Sharon's facial expression. She want to say something.
Know,
go ahead.
I already know. Matter of fact, God.
I read body language very well.
I'm not even looking at the screen, to be honest. I just got out the shower. I'm not beat to be trying to make appearances. Although I'm not a bad looking guy, it's not what this is about. The point is, if you know what you know, that's what you do. You don't have to go through all this, like, try to figure it all out. You got to be comfortable with you first. Because if you can't live around you, what makes you think she's going to want to deal with that? Especially if you don't even know how to make a decision for yourself. Like, if you don't have conversation and you can't speak, that's major. A woman is looking to see that you know the way as a leader. You stand in your dominant self. You know? We're not saying that there aren't control schemes
made. Sharon is shaking her head no to everything you're saying.
I know she's going to try to do that. That's the game. I don't care about that. My thing is, it's what I go by. It's what I've experienced. I don't have to prove myself in that regard. She can say whatever she wants. That's her life. She doesn't speak for every female, but I want her to speak on this platform, and I want to show her, look, it's easy to get on this platform. And everybody, ask everybody else out there too. I moderate. I like to stay in the chat because I like to make sure everything is kosher and copacetic in the chat, but I'll get on the platform too. You know, I used to be in the background watching, and I know a lot of things, but I don't like to talk about a lot of things. People who know me, they usually want to try to be in my space and be in my face, but I don't always want company or attention. And that's just me. That's how the Most High made me, you know, and I accept that. But you don't have to try hard. You don't have to try hard. You know, you have value too as a man. You have value. She came from you, your rib. No, if many men who have sisters have no excuse to be beta males, because you've gotten to see how women are, how they start. You get to see the effects of the bullshit in this world coming their way, shaping them. And you also have an opportunity to see how a man deals with multiple women in the household. And the men that remain men and have daughters, a house full of women, got to give them props. If they are men, if they maintain that masculine frame, you know, it's about status, sex, security. Security comes from the sex. It can. Finances help. So stability. I'm not going to act like I'm a know-it-all. You said it. You said what it is. So now I want to go ahead and address Sister Sharon. Sharon, I think it is. Spit your piece, sis. Say what you got to say on here. Let's hear it. I don't want to talk.
Oh, you're muted. You got to unmute yourself now, Sharon.
I'm not going to have to.
Hello?
Oh, you're now your YouTube's going again. You see, if you go to your YouTube screen in the bottom left-hand corner, and if you click that speaker, it'll mute your YouTube, and you just talk through your Zoom. I mean, through your StreamYard. You're muted again. You're muted again, Sharon. You don't need to mute your Zoom. I mean, your StreamYard. Just mute the YouTube screen.
She might have to close YouTube.
Too many programs open. Close one of those programs. If she looks, she probably has two YouTube programs open, and she has to close one and leave just StreamYard open. If you're listening, close them all, leave just StreamYard open. You can always punch back into YouTube at any time. And come back in and speak your piece.
Yeah, let's hear it. We already know what's going on as men. You don't need to hear too much more from us. You want to hear from the women.
Right, come. Yeah, we always hear from the men.
Just leave just StreamYard open and close all other programs. Leave that open. Only one program open, and that's all you need open when you're on the platform.
I respect it from coming in the room, Marty and Mikael, because most women won't even come in.
Yeah, me too. But she got discombobulated for a minute and dropped out. But come on back in. Leave just StreamYard open and close all other programs and you'll be fine. That's all you got to do. Come on back in.
Hey, Kahan. Yo. Yo, I'm just laughing. I gotta admit, I'm laughing because I know why she came on. I know why she came on. Yeah, it's crazy.
we were spitting that fire to her ass. That's why she came up. She wanted to come in and talk that nonsense. Mikhail, you know, because we be talking that real talk, Mikhail. You know that's right. But she come on back in. Come on back in. You know, we don't bite. You know, we just talking.
She's coming back in. She put text messages in the room. So click on the link and come back in the room, Sharon.
Leave just StreamYard open and you'll be fine.
All right, I'm gonna put one nugget out there, and I know what she's. I know the angle she's coming. Men direct the relationship, which is absolutely true. And all it boils down to is, what is the direction of this relationship? Why are you together? You're together to create something. But you got to, somebody has to be the leader. You were born as a man. You have balls underneath your rod that dictate that you produce the seed. Together, you are creating a family, a unit. And it produces a result. And that result is supposed to reflect the glory of the Most High. But what type of man are you? Are you a man? Are you trapped in a man's body, but really you're still living as a boy? Directionless, aimless boy.
Yeah.
And that's just what it is. At some point, we have to confront that.
Let me call you back.
We can hear you now, Sharon. We can hear you that.
Wonderful. Great. I'm so glad. First of all, may I say hello? Okay, so you guys can hear me.
Yeah.
We can't both talk at the same time.
So you're talking now. Go ahead and talk.
Okay. Well, because I can hear another conversation going on, so it's kind of hard for me to get my thoughts together. No, the reason why I got on is because a lot of times people like to shift the responsibility of these relationships that they're getting into. But the truth of the matter is, everybody plays their role and everyone has a responsibility to submitting to a relationship. And usually people get what they're looking for. So if a man goes out and find a woman that he's dissatisfied with, on what premise did he bring that woman into his life in the first place? Was he attracted to her sexually in the first? Because people don't change overnight. They are who they are. Okay. All right. So people don't change who they are. Oh, my God. This is like playing back.
It's because you got to mute the YouTube.
How do I do that?
Let me tell you again. Close all programs. Just leave StreamYard open only. Close all other applications and leave that open. You'll be able to access those back. Do that and you'll only hear. You'll be fine. Close all programs and leave just StreamYard open.
I can't. Doing this right.
Are you on a computer or a phone?
Where you see your program, you got that? So just have, if you have more than one program open, look at the top, X them out, close them all, and just leave StreamYard and you won't hear anything.
We can hear you, Sharon, very clearly. It's just that I think you had your YouTube still open. That's where you're getting like a feedback on your side.
And you got to check your lag and see if your mic has a has echo on it or reverb.
StreamYard, okay, StreamYard. But if I do that, I think I'm gonna click out. Okay, is that better?
Can you hear it on our side? You're having a problem on your side.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys can hear me without the back.
Yes.
Background sound. Okay. So this is what I was trying to say. I hear you guys complaining about Eve.
No, we're not complaining. We're stating actual facts.
But Adam is also an issue because Adam is attracted to everything with his eyes. And so when you're attracted with only your eyes, you get what you're looking for. She's displaying what she's looking for. And if you pick that up, then you're getting what you're looking for. But if you're looking for a spiritual connection, then you're going to get that as well. Why? Because you will not let anything else in your space. So what are you willing to share your space with? Men have to take a responsibility for what they bring into the left the same way we sisters have to take responsibility to what we bring into our lives as well. What messages are we as people sending? Brothers are sending messages too. So if all you're looking for is a pretty face and a big butt, nice fat thighs, and that's what you're chasing, that's what you're going to get. But remember, she's showing you who she is from day one when you met her. What attracted you to that woman? Was it her garment? Was it her mind? What was it? Was it her spirit? If it was none of those things, you can't expect to get something out of nothing. So what I'm trying to say is, if you weren't attracted by her conversation, by the way she carried herself, which was with some humility, if she had it all hanging out and that's what you went for, brother, that's who you are too. It don't get no simpler than that. You bring home what you're seeking. And so if you're seeking a sister that's got it all hanging out, that's what you're attracted to, don't complain when you get that home, because she's not going to change. And vice versa. Sisters, are we attracted to a strong man? Somebody who is a protector, someone who has wisdom? Or are we looking for brothers with their pants hanging down and with money hanging out their pocket, who's looking at everything with a big ass? See, you get what you're looking for. Period. We all share in that responsibility. It's not just Eve.
So I can agree to that to a certain degree, Sharon. But here's the problem. A lot of people, they're actors and actresses, right? Let me show you what I'm talking about. You'll see some women.
Con.
A lot of these simp beta males. This is why I'm making this video is about simp beta males. We're talking about the men that cater to this kind of spirit, right? So what you're saying is true to a degree. You get what you're looking for, but not always. Because some people create a facade, right? They create, like, you go to some of these social media pages and you see the woman there. She has on a nice garment. She's coming across as if she's really modest. But if you go and look at some of her older photos, you'll say, damn, well, how come she still had that up here? Why she still had that there? You see what I'm saying? So what she's trying to project is something that she's really not. And she's not going to display that forthwith. Like, she'll screen that, right? She'll try to come off as someone that's really modest and meek, but that's not really her. Men do that same thing. Men do the same thing. Some men will come across, typically, when a man wants to, like, seduce a woman, he's going to say all of the things to her that he knows that she wants to hear. But that's not who he really is. That's just his seduction method. That's what he's using to seduce her. So this is what the scriptures say. You got to try every spirit. And so, because you don't get what you're looking for, right? If that's the case, everyone would be happy.
See, the thing about, the problem, the situation, okay, so this is really the situation. Most of the time when we, and I had to learn this in my own life, most of the time when we allow certain things into our lives, one, we haven't even developed yet to even realize, because no one really taught you about mating and or how about courtship. Or the fact that you're supposed to be spiritually connected to each other. Most of us are taught about what? Oh, they're cute, this, that, and the third. Women a lot of times are taught, well, make sure he's a good provider. So at some point we're compromising. A lot of times we don't even know. A lot of this stuff is done out of ignorance as well. But what I'm saying is when people claim that they're at a certain point in their life, which is at a spiritual heightness of knowing, now you're taking responsibility. Because why, if you don't feel that spiritual connection, why are you even wasting your time? I've been by myself for 6 years now, okay? And when I say by myself, I mean by myself. Because I had to learn that it was more to being with somebody than, okay, he's liking me, he's digging me, he wanna talk to me, he's interested in me, he thinks I'm cute, he thinks I'm pretty. That type of communication. And is he willing to be a good man in my life? Now, I've opened the door and brother comes in, he's not a good man. He's not who I think he is. I'm trying to build him up. Meanwhile, he's pulling me down. It goes both ways. But what I learned through that situation, and I had to learn this, that we can't just allow anybody in our space either. Because a lot of times the spirit is telling us not to, waving red flags, showing us dreams. We're not hearing it.
I'm curious about what you measure a good man.
What do I measure as a good man? Somebody who...
What is the criteria that you're using?
My criteria for a good man is someone who is respectful, carry himself decent. He's not chasing everything out there in the streets.
But where are you getting this from?
Where do I get this from? I got that from basically my own father. Okay? My father, you know, adored my mother. My father was there for us. He never left. Him and my mother. My father died first. But my father was he wasn't one of those dudes that hung out in the bar.
What did your father get his criteria from, right? Because if this is just coming from a personal perspective, then that's useless, right? So let me just touch on a couple things that you said right here. You said that we weren't taught what to look for in a relationship. So your father didn't teach you that. It was his responsibility to teach you that.
No, spiritually, no. I had to learn that. I learned about the spiritual connection on my own. I heard my parents talk about my mother dreamt about my father. He was shown to her. She knew that was her husband before they got married. But still, even with those stories, I did not understand that. I didn't understand that. I had to learn that on my own. Some things you can't teach. Some things have to be experienced. It wasn't until someone came into my aura who I connected with spiritually, and there was a huge difference between connecting with someone spiritually and me taking a shot or a chance on somebody based on what they're saying and how they're trying to project themselves to me as far as who they really were, and me getting into a relationship, getting married, having children, to find out that this man is not who he pretended to be. Okay, but that also speaks volume because I hadn't yet came into the fullness of who I was supposed to be either. Had I would never let him in my life. So there was a lot of things I didn't understand about the spirit. So when we're talking about getting a mate, somebody to be and spend our life with, it's a spiritual thing. And most people are not looking at it from that perspective. And so then you end up with disasters on your plate. That's all I'm saying.
So again, I have to ask you again, what is the criteria upon which you're basing this? Because
historically, the criteria that I'm basing this on?
Let me enlighten you on our historical in dealing with each other. Historically, our fathers or grandfathers would decide what type of relationship that we would actually get involved for. And because they would select our mate. We wouldn't select our own mate. They would determine, they would coalesce with another family and say, okay, these two people are going to get married. So all of the so-called like physical attraction, all of that was kind of out of the window because you really didn't have a decision in that process yourself. They would watch this person and say, okay, well, I want you to train so-and-so to be so-and-so's wife or husband. When we deal with antiquity, this is how we would actually get involved in relationships. So this is why I'm saying, when I understand your father and mother, they may have actually had a good relationship, right? But if the criteria is based on good according to the world, it's not the same as being good according to the words of the Most High. You understand what I'm saying?
I said my mother was shown a vision of her husband, which was my father. That's still spirit. And even back in the days when they were doing that, sometimes these babies weren't even born. They were doing that based on family. They would promises that they would make to a family based on material wealth and things of that nature. Then you had some that would do it based on birth charts, how they would pick their mate. But at the end of the day, it still boils down to a spiritual connection. Are you spiritually connected to this? Because if you're not spiritually compatible with each other, you could be a good person. She could be a decent person. You don't have to be. She don't have to be a harlot. He don't have to be whatever they call for men. At the end of the day, if y'all not spiritually connected, it's not going to work. It's not.
That is just theoretical, because contrary to popular belief, all of our relationships dealing with antiquity was actually determined by our parents. Generally, the man would select who's going to be with who. A woman couldn't just go out and, oh, yeah, I want to be with him. He's attractive. He's cute. It wasn't like that. And so if you didn't love that person, you will learn to love them, because then the act of sex constituted marriage. Once that woman was actually involved in intercourse with that man, she was with that man until that man died. So all of this, whether she was spiritually connected, that's kind of more of a personal opinion. When you deal with antiquity, you can't show me that anywhere. You can't show me that anywhere in biblical history. What I can show you is Jacob wanted a particular woman, and the father didn't give him that woman. So he had to stay there another 7 years to get the woman that he actually wanted. Then he ended up with two sisters.
Mm-hmm.
And this is throughout biblical history that, you know, preferably the father would actually determine who's going to really marry who. There had to be some third party intervener. You wouldn't just be with someone just because you was actually attracted to him. Not biblically.
Oh, okay. That's back then. We're talking about today's society.
No,
I understand what you're saying, but that's not how people are getting together today.
Because they're living wrong. So that's why I say, what is the criteria that you're using as a measuring standard?
You asked me a question, so I'm trying to answer
He asked you a question, but this is the third or fourth time you interrupted the Kahan. You look like you might be a Hebrew Israelite woman, right? And this is a panel generally of men. So we have an order. We have an order.
I didn't hear him still speaking. I didn't realize he was still speaking. I thought he asked me a question and I was trying to answer it.
Okay, well, now that we have that squared away, let's just try to be mindful. If you could say, excuse me, when you're finished, I would like to respond to that.
It was never my intentions to cut in. I didn't realize I cut in, so I apologize.
Okay, that's fair. And that's accepted, sis, because we don't know that. We're just going by, this is the audience is listening, and this platform has a history, male or female. We observe order, respect, and sharing decorum so that other people can see that this is a unified nation of people. And not only that, we conduct ourselves better than those that are looking at us, and they're looking at us for a reason, because it's a very positive platform. And nowhere else are you going to get anything else like it. So I just wanted to put that out there. That's for everybody, because I am a moderator and I was selected under honor to be a moderator. All right. So I just wanted to put that in there, but all pardon, Salaki, and I'm going to stand back.
Oh, okay. No, because even from the beginning, I was trying to make sure that I wasn't talking over other people. So that was not intentional. I do apologize. All due respect, not here to disrespect anybody, but I am here to say, we actually are not, although we're trying to reconnect back to spiritual basis on how we conduct our lives, you know, that is not how we actually get together today. And so what is the margin set for us today when we're interacting with each other and thinking about being with one another, it has to be something more than a physical attraction. And most people, a lot of men are drawn by the eyes. Even when you have a woman that is satisfied with that man, is he forever still in what I call shopping? Okay, which means he's still roaming the earth with his eyes, checking out everything feminine. That's disrespectful to the wisdom that he's with. If she's doing the same thing, it's disrespectful. So how do we set the margin for today in our society on how we do things today? There needs to be, from my understanding, if you are not spiritually connected, it is very hard to, who wants to be in a relationship with anybody where they're not happy, where there's no unity there? They don't have compatibility. They're just coexisting because someone told them that, you know, once you do this, you can't leave. That's imprisonment. And for most people, that's what they do. And they're not happy.
What is your, do you have some sort of religious belief? Are you a five center? Because the more I hear you talk, obviously you're not an Israelite. Because basically what you're saying, you're speaking directly against the scriptures. You're saying no one lives by that. I contend that I do and many other people do. So you can only speak from your perspective, but not for us as an entirety or as a whole. The scriptures give us a standard by which we shall live, and it doesn't really matter whose society that we're living in. We should try to live that out to the fullest of our capacity. And there's some people that do use these criterias to select in a mate. And this is what we should be teaching our children.
Okay. What I'm saying is my mother and father's not here. Okay. I don't know if your parents picked your mate, but for the most part, most people don't.
Yeah, I don't mean this generation
that way.
I mean, we could do it from right now. I don't mean this generation, right? I mean, we. From henceforth, because our parents, they got lost. They didn't know the truth. But now you come into another generation that's learned the truth. There's a tremendous deluge of Israelites that's coming back into the truth, just as prophesied. So now that they have, they're supposed to teach that to their children and live by these standards. And so the criteria, the reason I ask you, what is a criteria upon which you're basing your judgments? It should be the Bible, right? We should live by that regardless of the society that we're in. So if we know better, now we should do better. And some of the things that you said, that was personalized, right? Because right now, let me ask you, though, but what is your, I guess, religious belief? Are you 5%er? Are you Israelite? Are you Christian? What are you? Because your head's covered. I'm asking you that. Or is that fashion right there?
No, it's not about fashion. I believe in the Most High.
You use the word wisdom. You use the word wisdom. When I was in
because when you go to the book of Proverbs, which has happened to be one of my favorite books, I don't go by, right now I'm not identifying with any particular brand of religion. I'm not. I used to be into the church. At one point I was going to the temple. I had to stop with that. Okay. I covered my hair because my ancestors covered their heads. Okay.
Who's your ancestors?
Who's my ancestors?
Yeah, it's not a trick question. Who's your ancestors?
Those who came before me.
Yeah, who's that? That's too vague. See, now you're tap dancing. You're tap dancing. You see what I'm saying?
God, stop tap dancing. Listen, you're not fooling anybody on the panel. I'm just gonna put it out there.
It's not about fooling. Excuse me.
Just making sure that's not the case.
I'm not trying to. I did not come to this panel to fool anybody.
So
what I was trying to say is that. Let me ask you a question. When you got with your mate, your father and your mother picked your mate.
No.
Okay.
I went to their parents.
Okay.
I went to her father, like I was supposed to do.
You went to her parents, right?
Her father.
Her father. Okay. What I am trying to say.
You haven't answered my question.
What I'm trying to, can I finish, please? Listen, please listen for a second. What I am trying to say is, yes, we should be living our lives according to the word. So I'm not saying that we should not. But in our lives today, we know that that is not something that... What was your question?
You're diverting off to a total different topic.
Excuse me, say that again?
Who is your ancestors for the fourth time?
The Aboriginals Americans that was here before the colonists came in, they killed them.
Sounding like a Moor.
No, I'm not a Moor. The Aboriginals here were not necessarily Moors.
What do you mean when you say Aboriginal?
The Aboriginal people that were here, the Native American tribe that was here, they call them Native Americans. The Aboriginal people that was here, my mother's Cherokee. I was brought up in the church. However, there's error in the church. Okay, they're not teaching the way they're supposed to be teaching, period. You know, you go to these churches and that's a whole nother ball game. Those people a lot of times are looking to fill their pockets. They're not interested in teaching you how to live your life.
They weren't our people.
Hmm?
The Native American people, they were not our people. They was Asians.
Excuse me? Okay. Based on the history search that I have, our people that were here were being called Indians. We've been called a lot of things, Negroes, Blacks, colored, this, that, and the third. Not everybody.
That those people essentially weren't our people, man. Those people migrated down here and they mixed in with the original people.
We've been called a lot of things. And that's the reason why I use the word Aboriginal, because there's a lot of titles that's been put on our people.
Salaka, sis, let me ask you a question. And pardon, Kahan, I got to ask this question while it's fresh on the burner. All right, sis, how long have you been watching this channel? How long have you been participating in the background, watching?
How long have I been watching?
Yeah, how long have you been a channel?
Not very long. I have watched, I have listened to, I actually found this channel through a friend who was teaching, who actually Tazadaq helped get his creditor situation taken care of. That's how I found the channel. The channel was recommended to me. Then I saw that there was other aspects to the channel. I watched another program, so it hasn't been that long. This is not about me fooling anybody, but this is about men not fooling themselves either. Sitting here trying to throw women underneath the bus when both women and men take responsibilities in the relationships that they enter into. Period.
All right, sis. It sounds like you're
fooling. What happened, sis? What happened, sis?
About what?
Well, I mean, I'm saying I'm kind of catching a little end of it.
I'm not being defensive about anything. I'm being honest. Both men and women have to take responsibility for what goes on in their lives, period. And I think a lack of spirituality or a lack of insight for some people who are trying to find their roots, for some people who are trying to live right, not knowing plays a huge part. Everybody don't want the same things. You have some people that are looking to live righteously, and you have some people that want to be about this world. You have to decide which side you're on. Period. Hold on, let me finish. You cannot pretend to want to be spiritual one hand, and then you in the world looking for a woman on the other hand, because you're going to get what you're looking for. Vice versa for women. You have to, whatever that is, you have to be true to that, period. Because a lot of times we invite this trouble in on ourselves because we are living on both sides.
Do you believe the woman?
Of the street.
Do you believe the woman should be submissive? The black woman should be submissive to her husband when she does decide to get a husband? Do you think she should be submissive, or do you think she should be more boldly? Do you believe in a 50-50? Relationship or marriage, or do you believe in the man should be the head and the woman should follow his lead, basically being submissive?
That depends.
Depends on what.
The fact that she's saying spirituality, that's that nonsense thing that a lot of these...
That's that African stuff. That's that West African type of culture.
No, I didn't study any West African stuff, the reason why I'm saying that.
Are you just telling you the antiquity of it, the origin of it?
Okay, this is what I'm going to say, okay? If the man is fit to be the head, then he should be the head. But if a woman find herself in a relationship with a man and this man is not correct, this is what I'm talking about. Because if the man is not fit to lead, how he gonna lead? How? If she's living...
Well, she shouldn't be in a relationship with him.
Exactly. Exactly. Exactly.
Miss Jackson. She should only be in a relationship with a man that can lead her. But see, this is the problem, though. This is what we talk about every day. A lot of, and we're not going to say all, but a lot of Black Negro women do not want to have a alpha male. They love to have a beta male simp that they can rule over because it makes them feel powerful. That's what they taught here in America about the white men. Just think about it. Everything is taught, is always taught. You don't need a man, but what they teaches you is that you don't need a Black man, because they always want the white man to help them out. They're always looking for the white man for knowledge and this and the third. So when they get a Black man, they're not taught, even as a child. You grew up in a household, your mother even didn't have a father, or she didn't have a husband, or she had a husband that she could rule over. So a lot of women grow up in a household where they don't have a daddy, or they had a daddy that was a beta male self. And so they grow up in thinking, well, this is what's right. I'm supposed to have a man that I could rule over, because I don't grow up in a household where the women talk that kind of stuff to, you know, female cousins, sisters, you know, whoever, blase, blase. So a lot of women, Black women, they don't want somebody who rules over a household, because then they start getting, oh, he's too controlling and he want me to be submissive. Well, you supposed to be submissive. Right. You don't supposed to be the head. You don't supposed to be the head.
Well, and I put it like this. The woman wasn't supposed to be the head, but things did change. Where
the white man changed it.
I'm gonna hit you with something, Sharon. You're avoiding
the white order. Man changed it.
You know why you're trying to stray away from the order when I ask you dealing with antiquity? Is because you're avoiding the order of the supreme Allahim, which is the man is above the woman, and you're trying to put yourself in comparison to the man. You want to equate yourself to the man. That's not the way that this world is. That's the way that the rules of this world has made it, but that's not the way the Creator made it. And that's not the life that your ancestors
lived. I agree with you. But
no, you don't. You agree, but your actions and your words has been totally in opposition.
Okay, I'm going to say I agree with you, but there's still a huge but there. A lot of
you don't agree.
No, I agree. However, let me put it like that. However, how many men are real men?
How many men grow up with a man in the household?
We're representing a small...
Hey, but check this out, though. Check this out. This is what I made a point about last night, Tazadaq. This is the point I made. How many women can tell a man what a real man is about?
Right.
How many women had a father in the household that was a real man? How many women had a father in the household, period? So how can a woman tell a man how to be a real man?
My father was in my life.
Well, I ain't talking about you specifically, but I'm saying how many women...
But what I am saying to you is how many men are really men? Now, that's not to take away from the brothers. Hold on.
Let me answer that question. You asked a question. See, you didn't even want to answer.
Yes. How many men are really men? And that's not to take away from the brothers, but most of the men are not real men because they did not have a man to teach them how to be a man. And in most instances, it left us no choice, us women, no choice but to take the role of the man.
How do y'all know what a real man is, though? So y'all grew up in the same household we grew up in. So how do y'all know what a real man is?
I got it.
That's my question.
How in the hell can
you take
the
role of a man?
Explain that to me.
Okay, I'll put it to you like this. If I got to work three jobs to take care of the house, You got one job.
There's much more to a man than that.
Let me finish. Let me state this. I got to work three jobs to help take care of the house. You got one job. I'm at my second job. You're supposed to be at home taking care of the children. You're not at home taking care of the children. Hold on, please. Let me finish. Let me finish. You're not at home. No, excuse me. You're not at home taking care of the children. You're off cheating with another woman.
The man should be taking care of them.
That's not a man. That's a boy.
No, Sharon, you're out of pocket. Now you start to get out of pocket because you're cutting them off and you're talking real domineering tone.
Man, she, I'm taking care of
I'm giving an example. Okay, now y'all being like on the defensive side. Excuse me. I was giving an analogy. Hold on.
You had the floor now for quite some time.
I've been avoiding questions you don't want to answer to, and so on and so forth. You don't want to hear nothing.
You just asked. Excuse me. You asked me a question.
The man shouldn't be damn home taking care of no damn children.
Excuse me.
Your responsibility.
Excuse me. If I'm off working to help bring money into the house to help support the family, the man is supposed to be at home taking care of his children.
No, he's not, man. All
right. If I am supposed to be,
you're putting that man in a feminine role, man.
The bread home. If I'm left to help bring home the bread.
That's a typical damn Eve right there. That's what I'm talking about, man. Our women are
bugged. I heard that coming.
Right,
whatever. Whatever. That's not typical Eve. That is not typical Eve. If I have no choice but to go out, somebody's got to pay the rent. Somebody's got to put food on the table.
It's your fault that you picked a bump. That's your fault.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, sister, right there. You can't pick a... Sister, let me talk for a second. You can't choose a bummy man. You can't choose a no good man. And then somebody says, I got a no good... Get a man that knows what he's doing and supposed to do what he's supposed to do, and then you want to worry about that. You can't choose a beta male simp and then say, he ain't a man, see? I gotta do everything. Get a man.
Excuse me, but that's exactly what Tazadaq said from the beginning. When we first started this conversation, what did he say? He said, people pretend. And so if you got into a relationship and somebody pretend to be something they're not, and the woman have to switch roles and she has to become that breadwinner, the man is not supposed to be out cheating, leaving them kids at home by itself. That's a boy trying to be a man. That was my
But you should have known that.
He made it at the beginning, right? Just like maybe she didn't show she was at the beginning, right?
That's why we use the Bible to try that spirit. You watch him. You don't sit down and you lay down and spread your quiver to any damn man. You watch him for a while.
Exactly. No one, first of all, like I was trying to say, we are trying to live our lives according to the word. But if you mess around and you end up with somebody who pretending to be somebody they're not, you'll find out that they're not who they are once you are already in that situation. You're already married. You already got children with them. Then what? What I meant by spiritual connection is everybody has a mate who they're supposed to be spiritually connected to. If we're taught that from the beginning, it alleviates some of the problems we have as men and women. That was the whole point of me saying that. I'm not saying not to go according to the Bible.
If that's true, why did men have multiple wives in the Bible?
Don't ask me.
Oh, so you can't.
Can a man afford to have multiple wives today? Can he afford to have 10 wives today?
If he can afford it.
You're trying to exaggerate it. I'm just asking.
It's to just blow your theory out of the window.
Can he be a father to multiple children and multiple households?
Yeah, he can.
If he have the right spirit and financially able, he can. I wouldn't suggest it to any Tom, Dick, or Harry. You know what I'm saying? But let's say he got money. He's a millionaire. If he's a millionaire, he has the money to and the knowledge and the brain and the right spirit to take care of multiple wives and multiple families, he can. It's righteous to do that. It's not he wouldn't be breaking the law of the Most High if he was, but if he don't have, the Most High says that the man should take care of his household. You know what I'm saying? So if he can't afford to take care of two or three households, it's not righteous.
That's, then. You said household, and that sounds like households. And how many women really today in our lives want to be? You got some setups like that. You do.
Yeah, you're right. Do. They don't want to do it. You know why? Because just like you, Miss Jackson, they're out of order. They want
out of order.
They want to be equal. They want to give a list of damn demands. And this is why they're by themselves for six damn years, like you.
That's a choice.
Well, they got that. They got that.
That's why you where you're at. Because you're the one.
I made that choice to be by my. I prefer to be by myself than to be shacked up with somebody, quote unquote, married to someone that I'm not connected to spiritually. Don't know how to lead.
Because of your arrogance, Sharon.
I'm waiting.
Sharon, we see what you're doing. And everything you're saying is how you acted in your marriage. And all you want to do is spout off about all the problems that you have. That's all you're doing. And nobody else is actually gaining any benefit. You have another sister that just joined this call on the panel who wants to speak. Can we allow her to speak? I'm getting tired of listening to it. Nobody's benefiting here from all of that. You can just say all of that.
See, first of all,
I don't want to hear failure. I want success. That kind of guy. So I don't know what type of man he was and what he was going through. Done. That's dead and done. It's over. Let it go.
This is the point I was trying to make, sister. Hey, sister Jackson. This is the point I was trying to make. The man had multiple households, right? And I ain't saying households. I'm talking about households. So, like, he was righteous. He had the money. He was righteous. He had the right spirit. The reason why a lot of black women say, I wouldn't take that because he got other women, is because they know once that other woman, the other wife, or the other wives is doing what they're supposed to do, that's going to make her do what she's supposed to do. A lot of women have got away from order, the right order. Children, women, men, Christ in the Most High. They hate that order. Esau don't talk our women. They don't need us, they shouldn't want us, and they should be wanting to be the equal or want to be the head. Don't be no less than equal. And so a lot of black women, they don't like the multiple households, multiple wives, because the other wife, she might do what the hell she's supposed to do as a wife. And then they're going to put a lot of pressure on the ones that don't do what the hell they're supposed to do. It really breaks
that's
down.
That's not true.
Hold on. All right, Eve. Hold on, Miss Jackson. Let Eve. You got another counterpart here. Eve. Come on, Eve.
Speak.
Eve.
Yeah, the thing about the multiple wife situation, you would know that automatically there's going to be jealousy there. Like, as women, we do get jealous. As men, we do get jealous. The thing is, they view each other as sisterhood. So you can't say that. A lot of wives, they have their strength and their weaknesses. They're good at one thing, and others are good at other things. So we can't just say that. Because jealousy is going to be
there. Can't say what, though?
We can't say that in a way they feel threatened, right? Because there is going to be a sisterhood at the end of the day, because they're all helping each other out. Just imagine multiple women cooking, cleaning, helping to take care of the kids. Like that, it is helpful to have more than one woman. It is. But the thing is, I wanted to go back to what she's saying. It's just more than just the financial part. Yes, you can financially take care of like 10 wives, but can you emotionally do it? Can you
That's
do
what
it?
I said.
It
you got to be spiritually. Then what I said, you got to be spiritually connected. You have to be a righteous brother that spiritually through the Bible, you know what I'm saying, that's running those households through the Bible. But though, like I said, even they gonna always want what's in that Bible. You know what I'm saying? When you got multiple wives around there, and you may have two of them that doing the hell they supposed to be doing, and you got one of them that want to bug. Oh no, I want to be equal to the man. You know what I'm saying? She's gonna feel some type of way when he's showing that attention to the other wives is actually being righteous. So they're gonna keep her in line. That's gonna keep that what that multiple wives for the most high to make mistakes. That keeps all the women in line. Because, like you say, women get jealous. And when she see a other woman doing the hell she's supposed to be doing, and he's showing her the attention, then she gonna get her ass right. That's why the most high don't make mistakes. He's not the author of confusion. You don't make no mistakes. That's why he made it that way. Because he know how emotional y'all are. He put it in the Bible how emotional y'all are. That's why he said when a man leaves, he said when a man leaves his wife, he's supposed to take the kids. Because we gonna make rational, logical, visual. See, men are visual. Women are more auto. Women are more auto. You could tell y'all stuff. Y'all love to listen to lies. Men, you got to show us. We're not listening. All that talking, visual. Y'all are auto. So that's why he made it that way. Because he knows. He said, man, that's why he, you know what I'm saying? Y'all are too emotional. So when y'all see a woman, the wife that's doing the right thing, y'all, they're going to make y'all do the right thing. But you got to get a righteous brother. Don't be getting on these little boy Negroes and tell us, he ain't a real man. You knew he wasn't a real man when you got with it. Mm-hmm. You liked his money. You liked his swagger, you know. From the get-go.
The thing is, when it comes to women in general, you can't mostly say that. When it comes to women in general, they do get the bad boys. Like I'm just gonna tell you then and there. Like
keep it real.
A lot of women like the bad boys. It doesn't matter. It's the white woman, the Asian woman, the black woman. They do like the bad boys. Or sometimes what happens is that a man can put a really good facade, right? Because we know men are really good at finessing women in a way. With the way he acts, with the way he dresses, he might seem like someone, I got everything together. So when she's with him.
That's the auto right there. You just said it. That's the auto.
Not auto, visual too. It's the visuals.
Not only that, let me tell you something. Women get a bad rap. When you see a brother supposedly, he's trying, he's doing his best, or he pretends to be somebody he's not. He's got a supportive woman. She's got his back. She's out there doing what she needs to do. She's taking care of the children. She's working. She's holding it down. I'm not even talking about no multiple marriages, because most of our households are not ran that way today. I wasn't brought up in that. However, nobody was looking for a bad boy, because everybody don't want a bad boy. Everybody don't want that. Some women just want a good man.
We're not listening to that.
But it's true. It's true.
Like y'all want a whole bunch of women, but you only want a woman that only wants you. While you can have.
I have to put on mute.
Con, because that's reckless right there.
You just reckless, man.
I can say that for myself.
Most women are attracted to the bad boy. That's a fact, man. That's
not all women. Not all women, though.
Over 90%.
I'm one of those people.
They want the bad boy. That's it.
I don't like bad boys, though. I don't.
It's not a subject for debate. It's not a subject for debate. We're all men. You're talking to the opposite gender. You're not talking to other women. We know what's going on.
How, as a woman, how are you going to tell women what they're attracted to?
Well, what he's going to do either.
Because you don't know,
but
this is why you won't even show your face. You don't know what you're attracted to. And this is why you always end up in the traps. Because you think, let me tell you, you know what a woman is saying? Same thing that Sharon was saying. I want a guy that treats me nice, does this and that. And she would get with that kind of man, and she doesn't even respect his ass.
Facts. Don't respect him at all. You know what I'm saying? He's too soft. Yep. No, so he got to be. You got to have thick skin to deal with a woman like me. You better have. When I hear that right there, I know that that's a smart mouth chick, and she want to try to. That's a finesse game, fellas. When a woman tell you, oh, you know, so you got to have tough skin. You know what I'm saying? Oh, you can't handle a way. You can't handle a woman like me. That means that she want to talk to you crazy, and if you don't accept that, oh, something wrong with you. You a soft nigga then. No. I don't hurt. I don't have that game trying to be ran on me. I'm pretty sure every fella in here don't have that game try to be ran on it. That don't work.
Yeah, man. These Eves can't handle the truth when it comes out, man. The order's coming back to the earth, man. You can like that, understand it, believe it or not. Either Eve got mad, she got her emotions because I cut her behind. Hell yeah, they want a bad boy, man. Mostly all women want that, whether they admit it or not.
They want a bad boy.
They're attracted to that.
You know, a bad boy and then complain about, oh, he's not a man. You knew he wasn't a doggone man.
That bad boy exhibits that he doesn't give a damn whether he's with her or not, and she's attracted to that. The bad boy is going to have a lot of other women that's attracted to him, and women like that. Let me tell you what women like,
Tazadaq.
Women are attracted to. Whether they're men or not. No, she's still running them off. Look at that.
Tazadaq. This is what they like, Tazadaq. They like the chase. They like the chase, man.
Beta male's about. E cannot control her damn mouth. And she don't respect order.
I can't. Hey, Tazadaq. They like the chase, man. They like the chase of it. See, you know what I'm saying? They want to chase that bad boy, or they want that simp to chase them. They just love the thrill, man. It's a chase, man. It's like a high for them. You know what I mean? It's a chase.
Yo, they like to resist, but they can't resist.
Let me tell you something, man. I know when I was in the world, man, these damn women, they love the bad boy. Because I used to be using these damn E's for a damn pump and dump. And they was always attracted to that damn attitude, man. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, man. I'm just keeping it a buck, man.
That's real.
Yeah, man, you got to keep it a buck, man. You got to keep it a buck.
Gravitate towards that, man. The woman that tell I want him to treat me. She don't want that. Most women don't know what they want, man.
No,
I'm telling you guys. You guys better listen to me, man. This is why most of you damn men are simp beta males, man. And you're always getting caught up in your damn feelings over the wrong woman, man.
Come on.
You guys better listen.
Once you put that Becky. Once he put that Becky and that dog on and that thigh y'all, we call that thigh y'all back in the day. Because once he put that Becky and that thigh y'all on him, he discombobulated up here.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying? And a woman uses her sexuality these days. I mean, you can't even turn on the game. You can't turn on your damn phone. They don't use that sexuality. They try to use that to finesse you. You know what I'm saying? That's the real finesse game.
It goes back to the scriptures, back to antiquity. That's why they did do those chosen marriages, because the woman really doesn't know what she wants at the end of the day.
She don't know how to pick out a good man. She didn't know what a good man was then, and she don't know what a good man is now. That's why the parents picked out the damn good man for them. Talk that talk, Benaya. Talk that talk.
Yeah, Sharon was saying you got to be spiritually connected, man. So what spirit are you dealing with, man? I was asking her, what's the criteria that you're basing this on? Your own feelings, emotions? Or what have you? It's got to be supreme Allah, man.
Got to be able to answer that question.
Ms. Jackson, what you got to say?
I thought y'all muted me.
No, yeah, we can hear you.
I'm down a little bit.
I based that off of me communing with my Holy Father and that being dropped in my spirit, that I needed to be spiritually connected with the person. I'm not a harlot. I'm not an Eve out there trying to beguile anybody. But let me tell you something. Even the Creator told me not to see the person that I was talking to anymore. So that is to be said like this. if I'm going to be with somebody, I need to know that that came from above. I'm not even saying me putting myself with anybody. I always said like this, if I do get with somebody, when I do get with someone, it's going to be because the Father in heaven gave me the okay to be with that person. I'm not jumping out there in a relationship with anyone unless it's okayed by the Almighty Spirit. Who drops that in my spirit? Period.
That's real. That's real, you know what I'm saying? You should be, you know what I'm saying? Just like the Most High tell you, you got to prove that person first, look past the outer interior, you know what I'm saying? Look past what the person's saying, but prove that person, prove a friend. So, you know, so you're absolutely right about that part. You should be proving them. When you prove the Most High will send you a sign to say, hey, this is the one.
See, Zeta, you're coming in on the tail end of the conversation. When you asked her who's the Heavenly Father, she can't tell you. Because she's been jumping over. She says she don't prescribe to any kind of ideology.
I don't. That's
what you said. Don't try to even back out of that. Don't backpedal.
Right now, can I say something? May I speak?
She's saying the Heavenly Father. Who in the hell is she talking about?
I'm talking about the Heavenly Father, the Father of Jacob, Isaac. I'm talking about our Creator. That's who I am talking about. Listen, just because I don't use a title right now, that means I am seeking knowledge, more knowledge.
Okay?
More knowledge. I'm not going to put a label as being Islam or Christianity or any of those things on myself because I've done those things in the past for it not to set right in my spirit. So I had to stop doing that. Right now, what I am doing is I am an open antenna to receive the word of the Almighty Creator. I read the Bible, okay? And I'm trying to reconnect the dots because we have been torn apart as a people. Our identities have been taken. So I'm even trying to find out how do we know or to identify as an Israelite? Or how do we know if we're Hebrew or not? Like, I'm confused about those things, okay? I really am. And I'm being very, very... Okay, so transparent.
The Bible. It's in the Bible. It's all in the Bible.
Okay, the reason I say this, right, is because I've been doing studies. Now, one moment I'm taught that we're more. The next minute, I'm finding information that no, we're the Aboriginals, the ones that they were calling Indians when they got here. Then I'm finding, okay, well, those Aboriginal so-called Indians are really the Hebrew, the Israelites. So I'm trying to find out on how do I base who I am on the information that I've been seeking. The only thing I have to go by is once I prayed to the Almighty Creator, asking for something to be done in my life, and maybe about a day and a half later, I heard a voice speak to me and say, nothing that belongs to me can be subject to addiction. Okay, or neither nor can be subject to addiction. So I took that to be, okay, I belong to the Most High. But still the identity, our identities have been stolen. So I'm still trying to find my identity as far as am I Israelite? At one time I thought I was a Gentile. You understand? I don't know.
Well, you found that out.
Do you really want
to find that out?
Are you just talking again?
No, I really am being serious.
Okay, so check this out. When people, these modern day Moors, they have everyone discombobulated. When you look at the etymology of the term Moor, a Moor simply just meant someone with copper colored skin. That had nothing to do with religion. The Moors today will have you believe that a Moor was someone that practiced Islam. That's not true.
Right.
You had Moors that was Christian. You had Moors that was Jews. And you had Moors that followed the religion of Islam. So any of us that was melanated was considered to be Moors. It was just a term that prescribed to a melanated person. It had nothing to do with religion whatsoever. But when you deal with an Israelite, you're not dealing with religion. That's dealing with antiquity. That's dealing with your nationality. That's dealing with who you are as a people. So when you say Jacob, you know, Abraham, that's not dealing with religion. That was our way of life. That was a specific way of life. And this way of life was actually written down in the Bible, right? So a lot of the people that refer to themselves as Moors are really Israelites as well. But they don't prescribe into that because they got caught up into science and they got caught up into religious philosophy, and they call themselves Moors, and they follow religion of Islam. But when you deal with antiquity, that's not them, because they wouldn't be able to explain how they got here. And they create all kind of things and say this is part of Africa and so on and so forth. And people, they expose themselves to all of this different information, and they become confused. Instead of just, really, our history book is the Bible. If you study that book and you understood it, then you wouldn't be confused about your nationality. That is our history book.
Well, I did become confused as far as nationality because, like I said, I was brought up in the church, but we were only allowed to read New Testament. And then when I went into the Old Testament, let them know I was reading the Old Testament, they was like, get out of there. You don't belong in there. That's for the Jews. Okay.
What religion was that? What religion was that? The church. What church
was that? Was the church. Actually.
Was that Baptist, Catholic, what?
No, it was non-denominational.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I grew up basically in a Baptist church. When I became an adult, I ended up going to a church that actually taught you the word of God rather than read you a verse, tell you close your Bibles. So once I got into a teaching ministry, that was non-denominational. They didn't go by any, you know, denominations. But I ended up pulling away from that. I was going to the temple, the Moorish temple. I ended up pulling away from that because we're being told that we're giving back Christianity to those who had enslaved us. We're giving them back their religion, but yet we're still practicing that religion. So at that point, I just pulled away.
Okay, let me say this. So Christianity didn't exist when you deal with antiquity, right? Jews was first called Christians in Antioch. The word Christian itself came from the people, the Nazarene, that was following Hamashiach, that the Greeks put the term on. They start calling him Jesus, a Christ. So from that, these people that was following him in the Greco-Roman time, they started calling those people Christian. And then they created a religion called Christianity from our way of life, which was Israelites. So Christianity, it's kind of like an offshoot of our lifestyle. See, what you got to understand, that Israelite was a lifestyle, was not a religion. You can't find anywhere in the Bible that the Most High gave us a religion. It's not there. Nowhere in the Bible did he give us a religion. He gave us laws, statutes, and commandments to follow. And that's what we're supposed to follow. When you went back and you started reading the Torah, the Tanakh, that's what you were supposed to do. Because that's where the laws are, and that would teach you who you are. And so what they refer to as the New Testament, it's the same thing as the Old, because it's always pointing back to what they refer to as the Old Testament. It's always referring you back to the Torah, the Tanakh. That's your roadmap to who you are, man, is the Bible.
That precept is in Corinthians, right? First Corinthians?
What's that?
The Jews were called Christians. First Corinthians
in Antioch, which is Upper Syria.
I was going to bring out that precept. Read it.
I mean, the thing about you, sister, you're a good listener, and you got a strong spirit. I don't know how these people. What you're talking about? Benaiah and Acts is Acts 11 and 26.
Come on.
That's the first time that our people was referred to as Christians, sis. And it was the Greeks that put that term on us. We was never Christian. Christianity is a religion. It's not a way of life. And that had nothing to do with us, man. You got that, Benaiah? Acts 11 and 26. Dawee, what's going on with you, Ken?
Chilling. Just listening, man. I want to get up in there. I just want to listen to a little bit, and then I'm going to put my opinion up in there.
I got the precept.
Bring it up.
Book of Praxesis, Acts chapter 11, verse 26. And having found him, he brought him to Antioch. And it came to be that for an entire year they came together in the assembly and taught large numbers. And the taught ones were called Christians first in Antioch.
So the Jews was first called Christians in Antioch, which is Upper Syria. That's when they put that term Christians on us. The Greeks started that. The Greeks started calling us Christians after that name Christ, by which Hamashiach was never known. He was never known by that name. And what you got, Dawid King?
Yeah, man, a lot of our people, man, through the centuries been hoodwinked by all these different philosophies. What it's about, this day is about knowing who you are and having some direction. Now, when you read these scriptures, now, what book in the Bible did you read that really made you ponder a thought that you the people of the book? When you, did you read the book of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter?
Well, I mean, she was confused, brother. She was saying she don't know if she's more.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying, like, now, if you read that book of Deuteronomy, 28th chapter, the Lord was telling our people through Moses, if we obeyed these things, we would be given these things. If we disobeyed, these things would happen too. Now, when you read that book, it's talking about curses. Now, if the people that claim that they are God's people, they're supposed to be living these curses today. This is for now. Now, when I look at the book of Deuteronomy 28 chapter, and it's the Lord put these curses on our people, the only people that I see that's living the book of Deuteronomy 28 chapter would be us black people right now, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, point blank. And this is not religion we teach. This is nationality. And that's what a lot of our people don't have or understand. They don't know they come from a nation of people. The Lord only deals with nations. He don't deal with religion. He don't deal with philosophy. He deal with nations. So when he set up his kingdom, he is going to overthrow nations to set up his kingdom. You understand where I'm coming from?
Mm-hmm.
So what we talking about, what these brothers is talking about, we talking about nationality, who you are, a birthright that was given to you.
I understand that.
Mm-hmm.
So what I have been on is that journey and asking myself the question, how does one come to that conclusion? Because there was a lot of confusion, but because the places that I was at, I didn't, let's put it like this. I didn't feel like belonging, or I felt a sense of sorrow. I pulled away because it didn't resonate.
It didn't set in right.
No, it didn't. So I continued to just pull away. So at this point, it's like, okay, go back, research. You know, go turn back to the Bible, because at one point I stopped reading that. I didn't know what to believe. Not to mention the books have been, you know, translated, messed with. So, but I said, okay, my spirit led me back to the Bible. So that I started that. My son was like, "Mom, you back in the Bible?" I was like, "Yeah, I'm going into it with a different set of eyes and not having somebody tell me what it means." And it led me back to going back to the Old Testament and starting there. And I've just been really just.
So you said you wanted to know what it means?
What I mean by that is, when I was in going to the church, basically, you know, they'll read some passages and tell you close the book. So, you know, I would go home and do some studying and pulling out this book, that book to study along with the scriptures. And but whenever someone else gives you an interpretation that let's say didn't necessarily come from your spirit, it didn't come from the spirit within it, but didn't come from the creator, it's easy to manipulate people. and I don't want to be manipulated.
And
I don't want to be manipulated. I'm really am right now seeking truth. Mm-hmm. I stay in prayer, and I think that being by myself allows me to be able to grow. And
But now again, Malachi 2 verse 7. So you know, we may not automatically know everything on our own, sis. Sometimes we got to have someone to teach us, right?
That's true.
Especially if we're coming out of Christianity, man. Our mind's going to be all discombobulated. And that's even yep. So going to a Christian preacher, that's totally in opposition to, because the Most High, again, he never gave us any kind of religion. That's totally in opposition to what the scripture is saying.
We know everything on our own, sis. Sometimes
the person that just came in the room, you got to echo.
Especially if we come.
AJ, you got to echo. You need to mute your YouTube. But now you still on here? Get Malachi 2 and 7.
Come on. Book of Malachi, chapter 2, verse 7. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
You hear that? No, I want her to hear that. You hear that, Sharon?
Mm-hmm.
Read that again, Benaiah.
Come on. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge, and they should seek the law at his mouth.
So the priest is supposed to be teaching you the scriptures, but you can't go to Christianity expecting to get the truth. He's the first thing that Christians, and you said it yourself, that they told you not to read the Torah, the Tanakh, the Old Testament. So how can they be teaching you the truth when they're telling you, I don't go back there and read that? So, right. I mean, it's
because of your
experiences. What I'm saying is the things that you've exposed yourselves to, this is why you have these viewpoints now. You keep exposing yourself to bad men, bad philosophies, and so on and so forth. So now they brought you to a state where you are, and now you're just utterly confused about what to believe. Why not try the truth now?
Well, I think, what I truly have come to a place where I'm not being led by bad men. I cut that off.
Okay, we get that. I'm talking about right now. I get
right now, I'm not even going to the church. I pulled away from all that. You got to understand, this is what we were taught. This is what I was brought up in. So even as a child growing up in the church, I started asking questions that no one seemed to answer. And of course, you know, you already demonized if you ask certain questions that no one basically probably don't even have an answer to. And so my answer was always given to me was like, don't question these things because you're going to end up going to hell.
Ask your question here then, sis. Me, Dawid, Benaiah, bring your questions forth right ahead. And Benaiah, get Ephesians 4, verse 5. Because at the end of the day, sis, there's only one truth, man. All this mores and all that stuff, that's not going to get you nothing but death. There's only one truth. You get Ephesians 4, verse 5, Benaiah. We like to answer everything with scriptures. Not any kind of personal opinion. Because all the answers is in this Bible, man.
Book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 5. One Allah.
There's one faith. As you would call him Lord of God, there's one God.
One faith. And one baptism.
There's only one truth.
Only one.
There's only one truth. Yep. So that means someone's got to be wrong. If only one could be right, then someone has to be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's not us, man.
The
Bible is an exact. That is your history book. They want to get you out of it. All these other philosophies, they might sound good. They mix science in with it, but it's not going to save your soul. Only the Most High is going to save your soul, man. When these people call on science, when things hit them, they're not going to call on their more science to save them. They call on the Most High. Automatic when something happened to someone, they say, oh, my God, meaning the Supreme Alahan.
Can I say something quick?
Yeah, Ken.
And the Lord don't deal with somebody get me the book of Amos, the third chapter, verse 1 and 2.
Amos 3.
3. Yeah, 1 and 2. We're going to show you who the Lord dealing with. And who the Lord recognized, the only people the Lord recognized, he's going to straight up tell you. Go ahead, my brother, you got it?
Amos, chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word, that the Supreme Elohim have spoken against you, children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
There you go. And so is the Lord dealing with this? It's just like I was going back to, the Lord deal with nations. That's families. Families represent nations.
Come.
So that's what the Lord is dealing with now. He don't deal with religion. He dealing with nations. So he telling you the only nation on this earth that he recognizes is Israelites.
That's it.
If you're not an Israelite, he don't know you.
Right.
He knows you by the law. The law. You know what I'm saying? That's how he knows who's who, by the law. Who was the law given to? Israel. You understand? Else,
man. Not the whole world.
Mm-hmm. And see, can I say this quick? See, this is how you know that every black pastor is a phony. You're supposed to deal with the whole Bible. Here a little and there a little. I think that's what Isaiah the 28th chapter.
Isaiah 28.
Right, there you go. You're supposed to deal with the whole Bible. And the Most High said, and the Messiah said, I come in the volume of the book. That's the beginning of the book and the end. He is in the whole book. The whole book is talking about him from beginning to end. So that's how you're supposed to deal with the Bible. You're supposed to deal with the Bible. You could deal with the New Testament and you deal with the Old Testament. You're supposed to deal with both testaments, not just one.
Come on.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? This
man, quickly, I have no respect for them whatsoever. None. From a kid, you know, I know that was rough, man.
You know what they? The problem with these black preachers is they've been set up by these white men to keep you black folks asleep. That's what they do. I'm gonna say this too. Being real, when you go to church, most of the day in church is singing and dancing. They ain't learning a damn thing. You know that whole fact.
Come
on. Playing a damn piano.
What's wrong with your phone, man? I try and call you, man. It was saying it wasn't available, man. You got me blocked or something, King? I'm gonna have to come uptown, man. Pardon me. Go ahead, Dawee.
Yeah, most of the day up in church is singing and dancing. Ain't nobody learning nothing. And what are they doing after the church service over? They got every damn abominable thing you can think of on the tape. They eating pork, hog maw, everything. They supposed to teach you the dietary law. Okay? They supposed to teach you the commandments. They supposed to teach you how to deal with your brothers and your sisters. And they not doing that. The scriptures say, can two walk together? Amos 3:3, except they agree. Unless we walking together, we ain't gonna never agree. We got to believe in the same thing. We got one Remy, God, man. One power.
Remy, you got me blocked, man. I've been trying to call you, man. I've been trying to call you, Clean. Go ahead, Dawee. I've been trying to call you, Clean.
Nah, go ahead. Whoever want to get in next.
I think his screen is frozen.
Not that boy Clean like Lennon. Not that boy Clean like Lennon.
What's up, Clean?
Clean like Lennon, man. You got me blocked on your phone, man. I've been trying to hit you up, man.
Not that boy Clean like Lennon.
Shalom, Clean. What's good?
I think you have a connection issues right now.
Yeah, Con. He's lagging.
Not that boy Clean like Lennon, man.
Yeah, that's him, man. He's been getting dirty. Now he's trying to come back clean like linen.
Clean.
He be out there getting dirty. Now he's trying to come back clean like linen.
You know you're gonna come in, y'all talking real greasy right now.
Yeah, Tazadaq, I heard you talking, man.
Y'all talking real greasy, real slimy.
Yeah.
It's just most I don't make mistakes. You don't make mistakes.
Excuse me?
Most I don't make mistakes, sis.
Meaning?
There's nothing by coincidence or accident.
If you believe in this and if you move close to the Most High, he will reveal himself to you. This doesn't come with religion. This is all scripture and faith-based remedy. You will get that here. You're not going to get religion over here. You're going to get the truth. And the truth will set you free. Trust me.
You know what? Because of these people that you dealt with in the past, now you have like this, you have this perception of men, like, and you're pretty much right. This is why I make videos about most men being a simp beta male. Then you have a percentage of men. I know men, I know a couple dudes in Harlem that used to hang out at a woman's shelter and wait for the shelter to release the woman during the day. So they could like take him to the crib and say, oh, come and chill with me for the day and so on and so forth and just have sex with him. I know men that look for women that is somewhat, quote, successful, unquote, and they're trying to hook up with that woman or impregnate her so the woman could take care of them. I know men that are actually trying to get with a woman that they think is successful just to live off of her. To eat off of her. So you got to look out for all of that kind of stuff. But it's like that on both sides. Because we've been taught, you know, by the system and our families. You can't even call me liar, sis. Most women, most mothers teach their daughters, don't settle down with the first man that they get with. Get him for all that you could get him from. To play games with him. To see what he has. What does he have to offer?
Get a man with a big rod and a big bank account. I don't hurt my grandma's them and aunties. I don't hurt all of them. So. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't got to be in love with him. You know what I'm saying? Get you a man, you know what I'm saying, that could take care of you. You ain't got to be in love with him. You can grow in love with him after you marry him. Get a man with a big rod and a big bank account.
What?
And these are preacher women. You know what I'm saying? That are giving these advice to young women. They're supposed to be telling them how to be sober-minded, right, and how to love their husbands and love their kids, like the scriptures say. I guess they forget all about that.
Con.
Hey, Divine Rebel, come on in the room. Divine Rebel, come on in the room. He said we need to be trying to... Now, he's half beta male simp mode already, man. We come on the board and put something like that. Divine Rebel, come on in the room. You want to rebel? Come in the room. There's always a Captain Saberhoe, man, that puts a cape on and try and come and save these chicks, man. And that's the beta man sip mentality that we're trying to get rid of. But, yeah, there's a madness on both sides. This is why we need order. And this is what we try and teach over here. Like, a man can't just lay with a woman and not have an obligation there. So you got to try that spirit out.
Come on. Order going to make it right on both sides. If we get rid of the beta male simps, that make it good for the, you know what I'm saying, for Eve, because if we get rid of all the beta male simps, it'll be real men around. Right. And if we get rid of all the hoes, it'll be real women around. Mm-hmm. That's all we want is order. That's what the Most High want.
That's all we want.
That's what the Most High want. We want what the Most High want. That's what our ancestors had.
Go ahead, Sharon. You look kind of worn out. You was going to say
no, something. I'm fine. You guys can't wear me out. I'm fine.
No, we're not trying to wear you out. We're trying to build you up. See, I'm always on the defensive.
Listen. What I was gonna say was
we're trying to make you a woman of the Most High.
What I was gonna say is when I first started this conversation, I said it goes both ways. All of us as beings, the creator's creation, we all need to grow. It's not just a one-sided thing. It's not just the women, it's not just the men. I'm not a feminist. In any sense,
sure?
No, I'm definitely not a feminist. No,
sure?
I'm really not. I'm
what do
sure.
You think about submission?
Excuse me?
What do you think about submission?
What do you mean submission?
Give me the book on 1 Corinthians 11, verse 3. It's not what I mean, it's what the Most High mean. You say you believe in the Most High, right?
Yes.
So everything I say, I use the Bible to support it. But now I get 1 Corinthians 11, verse 3. And then get the book of Genesis 3 and 15.
Book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man.
Is what?
Is the man.
The head of the woman is the what?
Is the man.
So that's what I mean about submission, sis. The head of the woman is the man. Let's get Genesis 3. Okay. This is what the Most High says. You say you believe in it.
I do.
This is the divine order that's set up in the earth. And until you're in a relationship that's being led like this, you're always going to get the chaotic nonsense that you've been in.
Book of Genesis chapter 3, verse 15.
16.
16. Bereshit, Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. Unto the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband.
Thy desire shall be to thy husband. Read on.
And he shall rule over thee.
And he shall rule over thee. That's what I mean about submission, Sharon. You see, the problem, if we want to deal with the problem, we got to go back to the root of the problem. And the root of the problem is these women don't respect men as they should. That's the root of the problem. Because if that order was enforced and she got with, and if she obeyed the scriptures and got with a righteous man, not just any man, a righteous, Yah-fearing man, then she wouldn't have the problems that she's having, man.
And what I was saying is that I agree, but there need to be some righteous men. Because just like
you have them on here. Right here on TikTok. You have them on here. She laughing. I'm dead ass serious, Marty. Tell him, Marty. We live this out right and exact. You've been looking in the wrong places, Zada.
I'm not looking at all.
Well, you don't have to be looking. See, that's the thing. Joke, man.
We try
to edify her with the scripture.
No, stop. I'm sorry. I hear you, and I understand the word, and that's the way it is supposed to be. That's the way it's supposed to be. Can't argue with that. That's the way
it's supposed to be. You gotta try the spirit. What I'm trying to get to you, sis.
I thought I was trying the spirit. I'm not going to even defend myself, because at the end of the day, somewhere, somehow, how that all went wrong is I failed at some point of hearing the Almighty or being obedient. So I eat that. However, I have learned from that. And that's the reason why I came into the room, because after hearing you guys talk about certain things, I felt like I had something.
But we're talking about strict men.
Yes, you listen. At the end of the day, I still felt like I had something of value to bring to this panel. And that was
I'm honestly glad you came on.
And that's from, you know, a woman's point of view. Not just the woman's point of view as being a woman, but understanding being a spiritual woman. You know, it is what it is. And sometimes I think we like to not really look at the whole picture, but there's a whole picture there.
I get that.
In other words, we can all stand to grow spiritually.
Yeah, and you're right? But the first thing we got to deal with, sis, is ourselves, right? We shouldn't be concerned with the things around us, because once we fix ourselves internally, then the things around us are going to change.
Mm-hmm. I agree with that.
EPZ, what are you talking about? Do I read the chats? Not really. You got something to say, EZP44, you could come in the room. I don't really read the chats too much, man. I'm going to have to end this pretty soon, man. I'm supposed to be in the testimony with this brother, man. Ephraim, the discharge $30,000. EPZ, you could come in the room. But what I will say, sis, you're pretty patient. The average woman would have left by now. You see that other woman that came in? As soon as I said something, she left. The scriptures say the wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous is as bold as a lion. She left. Most women won't even.
That's true.
I applaud you for that.
That's true. So you got a little patience, Miss Jackson. You know what I'm saying? That's a good quality. That's a good quality right there.
Yeah,
you're willing to at least listen. Hello.
You got to give her props on that, man.
Yeah, we're going to give you props on that.
I said something, she jetted. Proverbs 28:1 says, the wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous is as bold as a lion. So you've been standing here like a lion, Sharon. I gotta salute you on that.
Like a lioness. Con.
Let me tell you, sis, you're not over here for no reason. The Most High moved your spirit to come to this platform and speak up. I admire you for that. You talk with a lot of sense, but see, either you all right or you not right at all. That's why we follow the Most High. We don't mix and match what the Most High say. We follow this according to what the Most High say. And the Most High is never wrong. So that's what we do here. We don't deal with half-truth. If somebody come on here with that kind of nonsense, we show them the gate. We tell them, see you later, bye. But see, I admire you. You have a very strong spirit, and I do commend you for that.
Come.
See, a lot of problem with a lot of our women is you've been used to too many worldly men.
Mm-hmm.
Men that ain't willing to stand up. Men, check this out. For you to stand up, you have to have the spirit of the Most High on you to stand up. And a lot of the men that you see of our people don't have the spirit of the Most High. That's why they can't stand up.
Yeah, like the evilness of this world. She was saying that she was working three damn jobs, and that lazy ass nigga was supposed to be home watching the babies, and he's out cheating. That ain't no damn righteous man.
Nah.
That ain't no damn righteous man. First of all, my wife don't even have to work. I'm the provider. You understand what I'm saying? All men, they may not be in that position, but your home's not going to be as it should be. If both of you are out working, who in the hell is going to be watching your children or whatever, if you have children?
But you check this out. You notice I know something. That the garbage of our people never end up with each other. The men that ain't about shit don't right. end up with a woman that ain't shit. That ain't about shit. It's always the opposite. It's always a woman that's about something ending up with a bum nigga or the man ending up with a bum ass woman. It's never
then
two
always, that we
end up together. You understand what I'm saying?
Dawid, man, you call that on the dot. I don't understand that. I be like, damn, why can't the trash get with the trash? You know?
That's what I said.
You know what I'm saying? Because
that's right.
It's like a bomb. No, they can't. A bomb, no, another bomb can't do nothing for them. Whether it's a bomb man or the bomb woman. But I don't understand because the ones that got something, I guess they feel they can change the mindset of a bomb because they don't have nothing. So I guess they feel they can mold their mindset up something. That's the only thing I could figure out about that. I just don't understand it.
Well, sometimes what ends up happening is depending upon a person's what they go through as a child will either cause a balance or unbalancing in one's mindset. And what do I mean by that? If a child is abused, that child tends to be attracted to other people who will continue to display that same type of behavior. In the church, you're taught to see the good in all people. You know, you're taught not to judge. I think what my problem was, I had gone through a lot as a child, and somewhere down the line, I allowed myself to be played upon
my emotions, the tears, the whole act, and somehow question, second guess myself and my intuition and my ability to hear from the Almighty Creator. And that's where I ran into trouble. I do realize that, and I own that. However, those kinds of situations will force one to have to take evaluation and grow. So I had to repent for that. I do know for a fact that I did hear a voice say, "See this man, never see this man again." However, he kept crying and asking my forgiveness for something he had done. And I ended up letting him weigh himself down on me. The next thing I know, he done pushed his way in my life. But I take responsibility for that because I wasn't equipped. I was broken. So I take responsibility for that. Again, I had to repent for that. But that's why I came on the panel, because we have to be honest about what role we play in our own lives.
I'm going to hit you with something, those guys. We don't attract what we want. We attract what we are. We don't attract what we want. We attract what we are. So in that particular...
Not always. Because trust me, if the Creator spoke to me and said, "Never see this man again," it was not that I attracted what I was, but again, I moved in disobedience because I didn't realize that. I didn't realize that this was the Almighty speaking to me. You want to know what I end up thinking? I thought, okay, maybe I'm judging this person out of a bad experience that I had. I started to second guess myself because I allowed this person to manipulate me, and I ended up almost losing my life. I had to end up being delivered. And I'm saying that what I'm saying is sometimes we walking into a situation we don't even have no business being in for whatever reasons.
Okay, let me ask you this, because you're kind of getting off course. If we don't attract what we are, why didn't you attract the man that is loving and righteous and so on and so forth? You attract what you were at that particular time. If you had a voice that come to you, and you ignored that voice.
Not true. Sometimes, listen, you got sheep and you got wolves. And sometimes the wolf sees sheep written on the forehead. Let's put it like this. I didn't, because that wasn't my spirit. We wasn't spiritually compatible at all. I was none of what he was. I was trying to build him up.
You're still not answering my question. Then how did you?
I'm trying, because you're looking for me to give you an answer. What I just said.
You're avoiding the reality.
No. I'm not avoiding
change. You got to first admit that you made a mistake, right?
No. Listen. I think I said that. I said I had to repent because that was my error. I made a huge mistake.
That wasn't you. How did you attract him in that particular?
Because I had sheep. I had sheep written on my head. He was attracted to me. I didn't choose him. He was attracted to me. Okay.
This is what I know from relationships. Ultimately, the woman makes the decision whether she's going to be with a man or not. That's
con.
Instance. You're not listening. From the inception of a woman first seeing a man, she makes a decision whether or not she's going to sleep with that man. You think you're talking to someone?
Oh yeah.
You're still not listening. You're not listening.
You're trying to tap dance again.
No.
From the beginning, you made a decision that you were going to sleep with that man.
It was not involuntary.
Listen. You had control.
What I am saying to you is I made a decision based out of my experiences from abuse as a child. Okay, I did not make this decision based on where I am now.
You're missing the point.
I'm not missing the point. You made a statement, and the statement you made earlier was a very true one. Of y'all made a statement of somebody getting into a relationship, opposites being with each other. You get a garbage man who ends up with a good girl, or vice versa. I was testifying to is that is very much true. And the reasons that cultivate those types of situations a lot of times has to do with our childhood. That's what I was trying to explain.
Yeah, I agree with that, but your childhood makes you what you are today.
And then I also accepted the responsibility because I accepted this person into my life. I can never deny that. But he was not what I was at all.
Okay, but something caused you to gravitate towards this man.
I am trying to tell you, I allow myself to be
part of the decision-making process. That are the
decision. You know what? When I made that decision to be in this person's life or let this person be in my life, again, I second guessed myself. And I have to take responsibility for that. I made a bad decision.
Was he a smooth talker?
He was a manipulator. I ended up feeling sorry for him. But what this taught me is not to move outside of the spirit of the Most High, because I didn't realize that's what I was doing, but that's what I did. And I had to repent for that. I ended up feeling sorry for someone who I had no business feeling sorry for. And let me be even more transparent. This person ended up being a child molester. Okay? So we have to be very careful when we make decisions or allowing people to manipulate or using their tears and playing on our emotions. Because that relationship that I ended up in, this is a long time ago. I've grown so much since then. But that relationship I ended up in almost cost me my very life.
But that's what I'm saying. That's where you were at that particular time. In order for someone to come in your life like that, to be at such a dark place, you had to be in some dark place to not see any of this.
Did you not understand what I said? I said, as a result of some of the things that happened to me as a child.
I get that. But right? What I'm saying to you,
listen to me. It caused me not to trust myself. That place of where I was, the things that I experienced as a child made me not trust myself. It made me not trust the voice that was coming from the Most High or my inner spirit. It made me second guess myself, opening the door to the devil and allowing some destruction into my life. Was I at a dark place in my life? Yeah, I was. I was. Before you cut me off, why I shared this experience is to bring more understanding to the panel of why sometimes people end up in bad places.
Ultimately, it points right back to you. It is no one else's fault.
I said that you made a statement saying that we were one and the same people. No, we were not.
No, I didn't say that. I said you attract what you are.
And I'm saying that's not necessarily true.
That is true. Okay, so what attracted you? What caused you to be with this man? You made that decision. You made that decision. It was something within you that was attracted to that man's spirit at that particular time.
Was you basing him on his looks? What was it? Finance? Because you know he probably didn't have no damn money.
He did not. First of all, I was the one who built him up. I just said, like I said, I was taught that there's good in everybody. The person wanted to be in my life. I almost felt like I owed it to this person to allow them in my life. So I am saying when we're victimized as children, we also still will allow ourselves to be victimized.
I get that.
He played on my goodness. Okay?
But you allowed it.
Because of my brokenness.
I get that.
Okay, but we were still very opposite.
Yeah, but without the experience with this dude, you would have never realized that, because you would have never gotten involved with this guy If you thought it was going to be disastrous the way that it turned out, it was something, whether you admit it here or not, it was something about this guy that attracted you to him. Doesn't matter if you had like an inclination that maybe I shouldn't be with this guy. Ultimately, you still decided to be with him. So you're to blame for that.
And I take responsibility for that. And I said that from the beginning. But I'm also using my experience as a learning tool, because it's something that I had to learn from. It's something that caused me to grow as a person. And not for nothing, it's better not to have to learn certain things the hard way. However, there's a lot of growth that needs to be taking place inside of oneself before you even get involved in relationships. Meaning, if there's any brokenness in your life, if there's anything you have not healed from, that is not the time to be getting into relationships at all. And the best relationships that we could ever have is the first relationship we need to have is with the Most High. Okay? And not be secure. Because if that's not, anybody else can come in like a flood. Anybody. That's just the message I bring. And I take responsibility for my errors. Trust me, I do. I don't deny that.
It's clear that you don't really, you know, you speak very spiritually, but you don't understand how spirits really work. Darkness and light cannot dwell in the same form at once. This is scripture. Like, there's no concord that the Most High has with Belial, right? So two things cannot occupy the same space at once, right? What I'm saying to you, if your spirit was in the right place, you would have known not to be with this dude.
My spirit was in the right place, yes. However,
there's no
how. To be really honest with you, I didn't even feel comfortable. I was with somebody I didn't even feel comfortable with, and I didn't understand it. When understanding came, and when it came out who he really was, everything that I was feeling, I equated it to my childhood. Stay with me for a minute.
Dwayne, give me a precept for me.
Listen.
2 Corinthians 6:15.
Let me say this to you. If a child is violated as a child, okay, you may not understand everything that you're feeling. Like, I didn't understand everything that I felt when I was around this person because I equated it back.
You're not spiritually in the right place then.
No, I wasn't.
I was right and exact, man.
Okay, listen. Like, I think I keep repeating myself over and over. Let me put it to you in plain English. I was sexually abused a lot as a child.
Okay, I get that.
Okay, hold on. Let me finish, please. As a result of that, I did not trust. I second guessed everything that I was feeling. Okay? And I thought I was equating these feelings back to my experience as a child. So it caused me to have my discernment to be off. It wasn't until the truth out about who he really was, once his truth was exposed, now I understood. And I understood all these things that I felt within. Now I understood that it had nothing to do with what I experienced as a child, but I was actually picking up on his dark spirit, his energy, what was really in him. I did not know that. And I hope now you understand what I'm saying.
Okay, I understood what you're saying from the beginning, but what you're not getting and what you're refusing to accept is that you were still in a dark place then when you met this guy. And that's what you're not willing. And get 2 Corinthians 6:14-15. Let me show you what I'm talking about.
Willing to accept that. I accept that. But we were not.
But you keep trying to blame it on your childhood.
What I'm saying, it was a lack of understanding my spiritual gifts, what I was feeling, me being able to trust myself and what I was feeling. The message that I'm bringing is, if we're still dealing with things that we never dealt with.
Let's let the word of Most High go forth. Someone bring out that precept, please. 2 Corinthians 6:14-15. The scriptures are very clear, man. This is not about emotions and feelings, man. You got that?
See, this is where you're taking it wrong, because I'm not sitting here crying and boo-hooing. What I was bringing to you is a spiritual lesson that I end up having to learn. Because the truth of the matter is, we do go through experiences which help shape who we become as adults.
2 Corinthians 14 and 15.
This is the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 6, verse 14. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers.
So first of all, we're not even supposed to be dealing with someone that's a total unbeliever and that's in the world. Go ahead, read on.
For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness?
So you're saying, I'm telling you, sis, you were still in a dark place then, but you're saying you wasn't, right? If
no,
you wasn't in a dark
place, no, hold on,
you've been talking most of this conversation. Like, hear me out. If you wasn't in a dark place, your spirit would have never coalesced with this man's spirit. No, don't matter if you had a second thought or whatever, you still would have rejected him. Go ahead, Dwayne.
And what communion hath light with darkness?
So if you was filled with light, you would have saw the darkness and rejected the darkness in this man. Go ahead, read.
And what concord hath Yahweh Shai with Belial?
Yeah, Christ don't have no concord with the devil. So if you had a spirit of twice Christ dwelling in you, you would have rejected this man. Read.
Or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel?
Yeah, if you had a righteous spirit on you, then you wouldn't have been a dwelling around this man if he's doing wicked stuff. Read.
And what agreement hath the temple of Yahweh with idols?
You wouldn't have been in agreement with him. Read.
I am telling you, I understand the scriptures. I am telling you, I second guess myself spiritually. I second guess, and I did. And I am telling you that I didn't feel good being around him when it came
but
to
you stayed, but you stayed. My point
because
is
that's what we were it was
what I'm trying to get you to understand. If you had the true spirit of Hamashiach on you, you would have not been able to remain around wickedness. You would have not been able to remain around this damn man.
Eventually the relationship broke, but there was no harmony there. There wasn't. And there was no harmony there. There was not. My entire relationship with this man.
You know what? You know the only time you're gonna win, sis, and when you stop talking so damn much. You're talking and you're not receiving none of this. You're not receiving.
Brother,
you're missing
I
the
do.
Whole damn point that I'm trying to get across to you, man.
Listen,
what I'm saying, this is a fact. If someone has the spirit of Christ in them, they're not gonna be receptive to damn demonic spirits. And what you're refusing to admit is this damn guy had a goddamn demon on him. You say he was a molester, and you ain't see none of that? So something was wrong with you, man.
You know what? You didn't listen to nothing I said.
I heard every damn thing you
no,
said.
But
the same thing.
Listen, but you're not, you heard me audibly, but you're not hearing me. You're not hearing me.
What I'm saying? What do you mean I'm not hearing you? You
because
keep
what I said, listen.
What happened to you as a
wait,
child?
Hold on.
What I tell you, what,
no,
what you
but
child,
you're not.
You still had that same
you're
spirit.
You're not. What did you I
had
say?
The same
though?
Spirit on you no, when you met this guy.
Listen.
That's why he was able to manipulate you.
What did I say to you? Because of my own experiences, I doubted myself. Period.
But you're responsible.
I opened myself up for this conversation. I did not have to go there with this. I opened myself up with this conversation because this is how people who are of the Most High end up with people
you're not listening, but you're running your mouth and
whatever.
You're not listening.
You know what?
You're not getting what
I'm
saying.
You're not respecting anything I said. And what I said, if you really listen, then internalize what I said later. Because I'm not here to argue with
are
anybody.
You keep repeating the same
I am
thing.
Telling you because you're asking me how is it possible, and I'm telling you how it was possible.
No, I'm not asking you how is it possible. I'm telling you why it happened. I'm not asking you anything.
I wasn't in a
I'm
spiritual
you
dark place.
You was in
I
a
was
dark
in an
place.
Emotional.
You attracted a dark man. That's why it happened. That's the bottom damn line. You keep trying to tap dance around it. It's because you was in a dark place, so you couldn't see the damn demons on this guy, man. That's the bottom line. So what happened to you as a child, what I'm saying to you, is you were still in that same spirit when you met this guy. And this is why this guy was able to manipulate.
But that's what I said. I never healed. That's what I said. I never healed from that. I hadn't processed that. I hadn't even dealt with that. And what my message was is how we can end up in these type of relationships. When we haven't dealt with something, when we close the door to something because maybe it's too strenuous for us to deal with, and we end up going into the world, it's like you got a neon sign on your head. Victim. That's what I am saying. Yeah, if you're saying I was still in a broken place, I was. And it was not a time for me to be even engaging or entertaining a relationship. I hadn't even gotten to know who I was as a person or as a child of the Most High. Wow. I'm still on that journey of finding out who I am as a child of the Most High. Because this walk is about growth. No, a baby doesn't born here an adult man or woman. It's about growth. That's what I bring to the table. I can't hear you.
You're muted, Art.
I can't hear you.
Tazadaq, you muted.
Yeah, no, I was making a phone call. I kept pushing this other live stream back, man. I'm just other brother, man. I'm listening to Sharon here.
I'm done.
Someone get that Ciroc, man. Someone get that Ciroc.
Ciroc what? What you need? Ciroc what?
2623.
Oh, you know I got you right here, brother. You know I got you right here. The book of Ciroc, chapter 26, verse 23. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog.
No. Ciroc 2623.
Oh, my bad. Ciroc, you know, chapter 26:23. My bad. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man.
Read it again.
A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man. So but a godly woman
is guy, man. For you attract that demon, man. Like I tell people, you don't attract what you want, you attract what you are. That's what the scriptures say. I make this up. Scriptures say this.
Come on. But a godly woman is given to him that fears the Lord.
So she was in the right spirit. Boom.
God, see?
And she would have saw something
see?
In the dwarf. Am I lying, Dawee? Come on, Dawee. Keep it real, Dawee. Come on, man.
I keep saying to you, what I saw, I went against what I thought because I thought I was seeing.
Let me ask you this. For how long?
I thought.
How long did you remain with this cat?
How long, Sharon?
We were together for 8 years.
See that? You see what I'm saying, don't we?
We were, and the reason see, why, what, because 8 years,
you
see, man? We
were. You should have saw through that man's bullshit in 8 minutes.
I knew that from the rip. That's why I was silent the whole time.
No, the thing is this. The thing is this. What I said, I sensed a distrust about him. I didn't trust myself. Had I not been victimized as a child, I would have been on point with that.
You telling me you couldn't see that earlier in the relationship instead of going through 8 years of misery?
I had children with him. I had a child with him. So what did I do? I did what the church taught me to do. You married a person. Listen, I brought this story to the table, but I have learned I'm not there. I said this happened a long time ago.
We know you're not there, Sharon.
I'm not there.
We can see you're not there. So you think we're trying to blame you or something?
No, I take the blame. It was my fault.
We're not trying, but you think we're trying to point the finger.
It's not that either. I want you to understand it's not that either. That's not
you
it.
You know what growth is, Sharon? Growth, admitting that I made a fault. Yes, I was
fucked. And I said that.
And I'm you won't even let me talk, man. Now, entire conversation, sometimes I had to step on you, man, because every time I try and talk, you keep stepping on me. And so sometimes I got to step on you just to get some words in, man. But it's kind of like you're toning everything out, right? Mm-hmm. You're missing what I'm saying. You missed the whole paradigm. So that's why I keep bringing out scriptures, man. That's why I had to bring out that scripture. I was trying to show you at that time, despite what you think, you was wicked.
You had a wicked spirit on
you. That's why you attracted him.
No, I was not wicked because
What is that criteria to do based on?
Whatever. You know what? Forget it. I was not wicked. What I said to you was I wasn't trusting my spirit that was trying to lead me away from the darkness because I equated what I was feeling with the experience I had as a child. So I thought I was damaged goods, and that's why I was feeling what I was feeling. That's what I was trying to explain. You keep trying to say I had nothing to do with me being wicked. I had nothing to do with me being wicked. It had me.
Say, sis, we just read it.
Excuse me. If I was so wicked, would the creator would have taken out the time to speak to me? No.
Yes, he would, because he said it in Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 11.
Whatever. Whatever. I'm gonna let it go because you're missing the whole point. You missed the whole point, but that's all right. Trying to fix this.
Well, man. Wake up, Jacob. You finally got in here, man. What you got, man, before I bring this thing to an end? I seen you trying to get in here several times, man. Your connection was bad. Jacob, wake up. What you got? Jacob, wake up. What you got, Ken?
Okay.
Jacob, wake up. Jacob, wake up, man.
Jacob, wake up, man. He made it in the room. Now he can't talk.
Jacob, wake your ass up.
Sharon, we hope to see you again. We hope to see you again, Sharon. You got a good spirit on you. You got a strong spirit on you.
Thank you.
But you're still missing my message.
I didn't miss it. I heard it.
Jacob, wake up. What you got, man? You finally made it in the room. You're not talking.
I can't hear.
All right, we can hear you muttering in the background. Jacob, wake up. Seems like you're waking up.
Okay.
Wake your ass up.
I'm just trying.
Drink that cup of coffee with some milk, bro.
You sound like he's drunk, man. What you saying, man? This nigga will come on here drunk.
He's celebrating Christmas, man. He don't drink too many eggnogs, man. You don't do too many eggnogs.
Yeah, real saucy.
I think he's still waiting for Santa Claus to come down the chimney tree, bro. He
went back to eating Christmas candy. He fell out of the room, man.
He better drink an eggnog.
Nah, he was watching Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer on TV, man.
Sharon, you on the real Sharon, you sound like a pretty good woman, man. You deserve, you know, someone much better than that. You seem like a pretty good woman.
Yeah.
And you got a strong spirit.
Shalom.
Probably you had a strong spirit, man. You chased this guy off, man. And you just got what a bad dude, man. All of us been through it at one point or another, man. Always end up with that demon. But it's where we are in life.
You gotta learn from your mistakes.
You can't fix people. You can't fix people. No, you gotta write them off for what they are.
This is true.
Sometimes, you know, I could fix them. I could do this. Nope, no, you can't.
Nope.
The wicked is gonna be wicked. You gotta let the wicked be wicked. Otherwise, they're gonna bring you down with them.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of men that do that, man. A lot of men. Like the guy today, man, that I started off talking about, man, he punches a woman in the face. You gotta be weak as hell to do that, man. Levi, get from around there. He found out she's sleeping with three different men besides him. Now, how in the hell you don't see that? That's what I'm saying. That's where you are spiritually, man. You don't see none of that?
That's a simp.
She's sleeping with three different men. He finds out, he get mad, Zedek, and punch in the face.
He already knew. He had to know at least by one of them.
Come
on. He had to know.
In the face with the glasses on. And he got blood on the glasses. Now the cops coming after his ass, man. Testing it for DNA because he said he didn't do it.
Wow.
Damn shame, man.
Wow.
Yeah, but Sharon, you're on the right track, man. Don't go to more science. Don't go to Native Americans. None of that, man. Deal with your nationality, which is an Israelite. Don't deal with religion. Just deal with the Bible. The Bible doesn't mention any kind of religion, ever. Doesn't tell us to be religious.
We showed you who the Lord dealing with directly.
If you be patient, the Most High bless you with a good man, but you got to always know you're going to have that curiosity there because you've been dealing with damn demons. And it'll make you feel like you don't never want to deal with another man. Because you're going to have to always screen him like, is he just? Because most people, they put on costumes when they come out. They don't come across as their self. It's only if you've known them for a while. Then the true, see the way to test people, Shemin, is to disagree with them. See how they respond then. Yeah, I test people all of the time, man. I'll say something that I know they're not going to like to try and test them. And that's when that true spirit will come out. Say something they don't like. When you're always agreeing with a person, you're not getting the right, you're not getting the true person there. You get the true personality when you disagree with them, when you test them.
That's true.
Somebody read Ecclesiastes in the Bible 12:13 for me, please.
Let us hear the conclusion of the entire matter.
Is it 12:13?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The book of Ecclesiastes, verses 12:13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments.
Mm-hmm.
For this is the whole duty of man.
Mm-hmm. You follow a man like that, you ain't gonna make no mistakes.
Hey, Sharon, let me, are your children grown now or they're still there with you or with him?
No, I left with the children and the youngest one is 19.
Oh, all right. Damn. So they're pretty much grown.
Mm-hmm.
Damn. You still look pretty young. So you took pretty good care of yourself, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do.
Well, I mean, the good thing is that's behind you. It's done. Well, I'm going to bring this to an end, man. I kept pushing this other live stream off, man. I'm going to do a live stream at on Commerce in 2 minutes. So I got to end this right now, man, because I kept delaying this for this guy, man. So I'm going to end this and probably log on again, man. Got to do another live stream. This guy's going to give a testimony how he discharged $30,000 using the EFT that he learned at my webinar a couple weeks ago. So I thank everyone for listening. I say shalom.
Hope shalom.
Shalom.